Get ready. This is going to be an incredibly important week. I am on pins and needles. I have incredible butterflies. And I never get butterflies. I do get tingles up and down the spine. That's been intensifying as we go into this quickening globally. Really defining and deciding the future of humanity. We are entering the most critical time. We've entered the most critical time in human history. We've passed the demarcation line, the Rubicon, the event horizon. But I do have serious butterflies because the battle is joined. I agree with the video that Joe Biggs shot on the ground this morning in Philadelphia. Hillary, I can guarantee you, has got her finger on the button, her finger wrapped around the trigger. Her handlers do, to launch some type of false flag. That is the absolute go-to. Their entire paradigm is collapsing. World government is collapsing. The fact that they openly stole the election from Sanders, who annihilated her. The fact that everyone can see through it. We literally are finding 80 to 1 for Sanders on the ground in Philadelphia. I talked to Rob Due last night. He said, it's incredible. We've just got only a small crew and hours of footage. We cannot find Hillary supporters, and the ones we find can hardly talk. We've put some up. People think we're being mean. They can't, this is what the culture does. These people are zombies. Look at the cover of DrudgeReport.com right now if you're a TV viewer. InfoWars is going to link to this. Radio listeners can obviously just go to DrudgeReport.com. Burning hot. And then it's a whole bunch of Bernie supporters saying what they think about Hillary and the fact that she has split her base. And that's what the headline shows. Even the mighty Clinton News Network has the headline, Trump bounces into the lead. He's always been in the lead. That's even in their spin polls. I think Trump's about 10 points ahead of Hillary right now, and the campaign agrees with me, but I'm going to stop right there. Because of election fraud, and there was an emergency powwow last night that as soon as I'm authorized to talk about it, we're going to get into it. But they are fully ready to battle. They know Hillary is moving to steal the election. Why not? She stole it from Bernie Sanders. Why not steal the general election? You heard Roger Stone talk about it. I mean, this is epic times to be alive. And what's the Washington Post say on the front page of their business section? With globalization in danger, G20 doubles down on a defense. And who is our champion? The white knight at the front of the battle. What is he saying our credo will be?
Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo.
That's right. And the era of our economic surrender is over. There's no way you'd hear that come out of the mouth of someone who wasn't absolutely committed, and by the way, ready to die. Donald Trump is on fire. Donald Trump has never felt anything like the energy now seething to resist tyranny. The spirit of Americana and the providence that God gave us is now coursing through Donald Trump. And only those of us at that level of true Americana are there with him. But more and more people are coming into the animating contest right now. And you can feel the souls turning towards liberty right now. The globalists knew this was coming, so they put out their little fake archetypes like Bane bringing in socialism and the fire goes up. The little fake tough guy voice. Let me tell all the pseudo-Banes out there. The fire does go up. But it burns those who wish to extinguish it. I'm Alex Jones. This is the animating contest of liberty. The Russians have attacked the globalist occupying force and gone into their servers and are data dumping. More to come. Thank you for joining us, my friends. It's Monday, the 25th day of July 2016. An amazing time to be alive. Whoa. The energy on this planet is going way up right now. And the crone-like evil of Debbie Wasserman Schultz and Hitlery and all the flashbacks to their own admissions, not just the Russian hacks, And it is the Russians. That's already come out. I knew when I heard about it, it was the Russians and others who are going into the Democratic Party systems over the last few years and just reading the criminal plans to start wars in Russia, to overthrow the Middle East and put ISIS and Al-Qaeda in charge, to overthrow the family here, to break down the borders, to ship in millions of jihadis, to attack the Russian borders and bring in jihadis into their area. This is a globalist attack against all nations. This is the attempt to bring down what's left of the United States and Russia and then dictate to us the terms of the economic surrender. That's what's going on. And China sits in the middle of it as the main economic combine to leverage out all industrial capacity of the rest of the world. And the Chinese people are used as proto-robots, androids, who will work 16, 17, 18 hours a day for almost no food to just overthrow the living, livable wage of the planet. And if you think the Chinese have brought down the world standard of living for the average person, wait until the robots get online. And that's the socialist and globalist plan, admittedly, is to replace us with robots post-haste and then dictate the terms of our surrender. Well, let's guess what? They don't want us to know there's a war. Let's come out in these emails. They don't ever want to admit there's this program even going on. But here's the deal. Once people realize there's a war, I've got hundreds of key stories, but I'm going back over this because it's a prime rule. If we don't know there's a war, and if we don't know who runs the war, and if we don't know what the goals of the war are, and if we don't know how they prosecute the war, we don't have a snowball's chance in Hades of ever being able to stop it. But if we're aware of the war, game over. Game over. Game over. And Donald Trump is coming out and explaining that we've been under economic surrender, that Hillary is a communist Chinese agent, bare minimum. I know he's got the same people telling him that are telling me that, but I can see her actions over the years. But the Pentagon, the CIA, the people in those groups that aren't corrupt know that. That's why General Flynn was chanting Hillary for prison, lock her up on the floor. And they came up to the former head of defense intelligence. And they said, sir, you're involved in this? He said, absolutely. She's a criminal and needs to be arrested because she is. And he knows he's putting his life in his hands when he goes on TV shows and says national news and says Obama is commanding Al-Qaeda and ISIS and ordering us to aid them. And the host says, well, oh, so he didn't know and accidentally aided them. And he goes, no, consciously for years. This is a plan. It's a fact. And look, what's happening is they can't intimidate everybody. People early on, like Matt Drudge and myself and others, hit the barbed wire to tell people what was happening, and the NSA whistleblowers and the military whistleblowers and the folks from Benghazi, the heroes. Because in the beginning, a patriot's a scarce man, hated, feared, and scorned, but in time, when his cause succeeds, the timid join him, because then it costs nothing to be a patriot. We're now reaching the event horizon. We're entering the event horizon. In fact, I've always said we're approaching it so that we've already entered it in the last few months. So I need to explain, we are now well in to the big event. But it's not just some big event that's pre-scripted. You are history's actors. You really have power. They want to tell you, Republican neocons, Democrat operatives, they want to tell you that they are history's actors. They want to tell you that they're all powerful and that they control everything. And that you shouldn't even try because you don't have any power. They don't want you to even get on the field. Well, guess what? People are getting on the field. They're having devastating success and victories. They're building their confidence. We're getting stronger. They're getting weaker. And there is Donald Trump out there saying the era of our economic surrender to foreign agents is over. Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo.
Will be our credo.
That's right. Absolutely. Let's play that again because it's so important for everybody to hear it.
Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo.
I'm going to hammer that.
We will no longer surrender this country or its people to the false song of globalism.
The era of economic surrender will finally be over.
And what does the Washington Post say with total fear? What does Bloomberg say today as well? With globalization in danger, G20 double down on a defense. Finance chiefs, that's the bankers that took over by fraud from the world's biggest economies that admit they rigged the stock market, the interest rates, the currency rates, everything. The wizards, just the con men who have money machines that we pay for. Finance chiefs from the world's biggest economies signaled escalating concern about a wave of anti-globalization sentiment that threatens core principles long embraced by the group. Leaders from China, the UK, European Union are all meeting with the WTO and others, scrambling to double down their defense of globalism. Let's translate that. With the world awakening to the shadow corporate dictatorship, the directors of the Combine meet to announce a counter-offensive against humanity in an attempt to reestablish the embryonic stages of the world government metastasization. Oh, there's no world government. Oh, there's no private Federal Reserve. Oh, there's no Bilderberg or Davos meeting. None of that's even, remember that? That's not even happening. Hillary said before there were not even emails. In fact, she's out again saying she doesn't even know about emails. When they asked her about Turkey and the Turkish ambassador in Benghazi, she said Turkey's knowing that her viewers, her constituents, don't know there's a country called Turkey. And by the way, I'm not joking when I say that. The average Hillary voter sounds like a lobotomized Muppet. And I don't say that meanly. These are damaged people. These are formula babies who are on all sorts of psychotropics, who've been on welfare watching daytime TV for 30, 40 years, and they can't even suck their thumbs. We have the shocking videos. We're going to be playing some of them. Then you listen to the Bernie supporters. They're actually well-spoken, focused, and intelligent. Because Bernie talked about the real problems. His solutions were what were bad. The video's up on Infowars.com. It's the top story on DrudgeReport.com. Video, Bernie voters hate Hillary. Proof Trump can win in November, Hillary splitting her own base. Well, it's beyond that. It's a great article by Kit, and he also did the interviews. He's up there in Philadelphia, Kit Daniels, but the headline really is, and the news shows it, they're all chanting that they're not going to vote for. Most of the delegates are now saying it. They're saying, we don't care what superdelegates say. You stole California. You announced who was going to win a day before. That's fraud. The same thing that happened when they tried in the primary to say that superdelegates mattered, your vote doesn't matter. That con game failed with Trump supporters and Republicans. Democrats, it's been more slow burn, but now, pun intended, it is burning down the House. Bernie Sanders supporters chant, lock her up in Philadelphia protest against Clinton. Here's that clip.
Good morning, Florida!
That's Debbie Wasserman Schultz.
It's so wonderful to be able to be here.
Talk about it. Now, I have the flashback from 2015. It's linked up on Drudge for the Daily Mail that actually had them saying, we don't care if Bernie's really winning. We're going to steal the delegates and give them to superdelegates because, quote, it's time for a woman and women are in charge and we're going to do what we want. And then we have Hillary supporters on the ground saying, oh, yes, I don't care if Bernie really won. We stole it. So total arrogance, total megalomania out in the open saying, we're God, your vote doesn't count. Now be quiet, shut up. They're panicking. A revolt is on. It is incredible. So I guess I spoke too soon about Democrats when they didn't stand up against this earlier. They just haven't had a voice because the media has been suppressing it. This is huge.
I cannot help asking those who have caused this situation, do you realize now what you've done?
Speaking nearly a month ago, President Vladimir Putin at the International Economic Forum in St. Petersburg, Russia, warned the group of international journalists there repeatedly that Europe, the United States, and Russia were drifting towards full-scale war.
We know year by year what's going to happen, and they know we know. It's only you that they tell these fables and you buy it and spread it to the citizens of your countries. Your people do not feel a sense of the impending danger. This is what worries me. How do you not understand that the world is being pulled in an irreversible direction? That is the problem. But they pretend like nothing's going on. I don't even know how to get through to you people anymore.
And the big news is, a month later, almost a month later, after we first reported on it, in mid-June, there has been almost no Western coverage of it at all. And that's exactly what Putin was getting at. Whether you love Putin or hate Putin, if the leader of Russia, with thousands of intercontinental ballistic missiles and cruise missiles, is telling the West, I don't know how to get through to you, your media is controlled, you're being manipulated, NATO is putting missiles on our borders, we're having to move missiles in, you've overthrown Ukraine, you're on an offensive, you're funding and protecting radical Islam, do you know what you've done? Do you know what you've done, as he said at the UN, destabilizing the Middle East? Why are you doing this? Where are the sound minds across the political spectrum who should be stopping this? Russia has three overseas military bases. You have hundreds. You have your spies inside our country trying to overthrow it. You have your CIA people trying to get into our embassies. You are at war with us. And the average American, the average European, the average Brit is not aware of this.
Another threat that President Obama mentioned was ISIS. Well, who on earth armed them? Who helped to arm the Syrians that were fighting against Assad? Who created the necessary political climate that facilitated this situation? Who pushed for the delivery of arms to the area?
But the issue of a major world leader saying that we're moving to the brink of war, and it's not in our news, that's the big story. It shows how incredibly controlled things are. Please spread this video far and wide, and hopefully it will spur a debate that can cause some type of chain reaction that reverses our course, or at least changes our course from assured Armageddon. But they will pay attention when we, the people, force the issue. And we are forcing the issue on this, as well as many other issues going on here in the United States and around the world. I'm Alex Jones, signing off for InfoWars.com. If you're watching or listening to this transmission, you are the hope. You are the resistance. Future of the world is on a knife's edge right now. I do not have the semantical thesaurus or lexicon to be able to express to you the incredible import of the time we're in now in the event horizon, in the jump point, in the critical embryonic development of humanity. We have now reached a life or death situation for the species and the planet. Will a technocracy of world government private banks be able to destroy the nation state and bring in its final goal of eugenics and world population forced reduction? Or will humanity awaken and rally and throw off the chains of this technocracy? Clearly, there are Russian-affiliated groups that went in and exposed that ClimateGate was a plan to tax the nation state and bankrupt it, and Putin came out and said that. Bravo to the Russians. We're occupied by globalists. They're not attacking America. The Russians have never in modern times gotten involved in our elections. George Soros is in their elections trying to overthrow Russia on record. There's massive sanctions on Russia. So, yes, Russia clearly has gone into the servers of the Democrats so they can know what these criminals are up to, and they understand what everyone's facing, and so they're releasing how they stole the election, how they're criminals, all of it. It's now coming out. Project Veritas is joining us. Delegates admitting they met with Hillary, her plan to ban guns. The plan is put in up to 5 Supreme Court justices. If Hillary Clinton gets into office and stays in office and gets these judges in, it will go to civil war down the road, and everyone knows it. We cannot have Hillary. She has stolen the election. But Leanne McAdoo, getting ready for the nightly news tonight. She's going to be hosting the fourth hour today. Look forward to that. Did a great job, by the way, in Cleveland, along with Margaret Howell and the rest of the crew. She had some really good points to make about what's happening with Debbie Wasserman Schultz, who's being booed off the stage. And I cannot state enough to you the critical moment we've reached here. I first want you to talk about this, Leanne, and see if you concur. I believe they're going to stage a false flag, something to make Hillary look like a victim, an assassination attempt. I don't wish any harm against her. They keep trying to push that narrative. They've got to make her look like a victim because people have turned against her. They know she stole the election. The emails are out. They would send the Bernie people dressed up, or her people burst up like Bernie to attack folks, to attack the Trump people, to get a fight going there. It's all coming out, and now almost everyone we talk to, even on the convention floor, says they're not going to go along with the superdelegates. We're about to see a giant revolt here, but you've got a great point about Wasserman Schultz. Go ahead.
Yes, well, I actually agree with you on what's happening. It's absolutely, we're seeing a tremendous turning point here, and I've been saying this for months. I absolutely think there's going to be some sort of a false flag or something, because they are losing this right now. They're losing the narrative with the leak of these emails. And so many people, we saw on Twitter Saturday when the DNC leaks were really trending, Jack from Twitter was suppressing the hashtag and then started suppressing the second hashtag. They really do not want people to understand what's happening here, but it's too late. The people know and they see, which is why you're seeing Debbie Wasserman Schultz getting booed off the stage. And people were saying there was another hashtag, Bernie must disavow. And so this was the big thing that they said, oh, well, Wasserman Schultz, she got taken off of the the DNC chairwoman, but now she's going to work for Hillary, as if she has been working for Hillary the entire time. So it's almost like a slap in the face to the American people. Like, yeah, I know that I swayed the election in favor of Hillary Clinton, but now I'm going to go work for her and be officially on her payroll. I mean, it's totally sick. And then as this is going off, I tweeted it out right before I fell asleep. I was like, we'll find out tomorrow whether or not the mainstream media, the establishment media, if they are going to get into the contents of these emails, or if they're going to say, well, what's more importantly is who's behind this hack, also known as the Russians. And so now they're pushing out this narrative that, like, the Russians are just these terrible people and these amazing hackers.
It's bad that they hack the DNC. Who doesn't put up proper security. And, oh, but it's okay, as you said earlier, that Hillary, though, that she had this open server for years.
Well, exactly. And so people were saying, well, obviously the Russians must have hacked in and gotten access to Hillary Clinton's emails on her non-secured server that she had set up in her bathroom. And they're like, no, that never happened. But they also want us to believe at the same time that the Russians are these master hackers who have hacked into the DNC emails and that they're leaking these to sway the election. So what is it? What is it?
I have never been more excited, both upset but also excited in a positive way because so much good's happening. I mean, Leanne, I don't think it's any exaggeration to say this is the most critical time in human history right now.
Oh, I absolutely agree with you. I mean, humanity is awakening, and that's why we're seeing people try to really shut down on the internet. And our ability to speak with other people in different countries to get the real story.
That's right. Leanne, we'll talk to you in the fourth hour. You're going to be hosting. The big news is straight ahead. Trump has turbocharged massively into the lead. All right, let's get to the news. I've got to just somehow go over all this epic news. The most insane stuff I've ever seen is happening. Yesterday we talked about the fact that at the baseball stadium they're using for part of this event, they got three tents set up. They have this tent set up at the baseball stadium for the media, just like they had a parking garage at the RNC with Media Row. And there was a red, white, and blue section that they were just already using because that's how the baseball area was set up. And they got rid of the white section, saying it might be racist to have a white section. This is mind control. Well, if you thought the BBC coming out and saying last week, 2 weeks ago, should we get rid of the term terrorist, they've now done it. But it goes further. When the bombers and shooters and attackers have names like Ali or Muhammad, they're giving them names like David. Why not say David Jones did it, for that matter? I was reading these headlines, and Paul Watson's got one where it talks about they changed it from Ali and then his last name to David in the last name. BBC scrubs Ali from Munich killer's name on TV in articles and social media. Woo! That is amazing. And by the way, they keep coming out, and they keep saying that these aren't pledging allegiance to ISIS, and then always days later, people actually go look at their social media and their pledge allegiance to ISIS and are communicating them in every case. And I was on Media Row and they'd have Democrats I was being interviewed by going, that's not true. That's not true. They never pledged allegiance, even though it's admitted now. And you look at them, I go, you know, you're wrong. They'll just get real mad and say, this is my show. Get out of here if you don't like it. I'm like, well, sure, I'll go to the next show. It's just pathetic. Like, I couldn't do the interviews. I could do hundreds of interviews a day if I wanted to. Hundreds. I'm not bragging. It's just a fact. Everywhere I went, I was mobbed by TV cameras. But it was the hissing and the weirdness and the weakness of their faces and the anger and the soullessness and the fact they know they're liars. Their spirit was so weak, and I just couldn't be near them. These people. Let's look at Wasserman Schultz and one of their minions getting up there to try to corral the delegates to tell them this is who you're going to claim you're for, even though you were for Sanders. And they start booing her, and they're like, hold on, stop that, you quit that. Here, let's turn up the audio of this.
It is so wonderful to be able to be here in my home, with my home state. All right, everybody now, settle down. Everybody settle down, please.
Let's get in line. Let us steal your vote. It's no big deal. It's no big deal. Your vote never counted. No big deal. The Republicans, listen, I'm holding up my power hand. I have power. This went on and on. Oh, but she's resigning now to go work for Hillary because she never worked for Hillary. So she'll be one of her chief of staff in one of her areas. And then, and then Hillary runs the DNC. Well, she's the nominee. It's blowing up in their face. I had gotten really mad at the Democrats saying, what is your major problem? Why aren't you fighting this harder? Then they never had a voice. They don't have independent media. They have fake stuff run by Al Gore and the Saudis. And Qatar, you know, the Young Turks funded by that. And they won't put up a real defense. The NPR won't do it. CNN won't do it. They don't have a voice. Well, they got one now at that convention with what they're doing, and you get ready for the fireworks. We got James O'Keefe with our crew on the ground coming up with big breaking news. They have video. It's on Infowars.com. An Infowars exclusive. O'Keefe's given it to us, hoping it goes viral. Project Veritas with superdelegates, you name it, on video saying, oh, I met with Hillary. Yeah, she's going to go after the guns once she's in. She's got to act like she's moderate now. It is incredible. But we already know that's the plan, but the video's up on Infowars.com, red link. Now, before I go any further, I'm not complaining. Let me just give you a status report. We are in thousands of articles a week, hundreds of TV stations. Globalism is being exposed. The narrative of the globalism's captured America is getting out there. We're having devastating victories. InfoWars is unfortunately the very tip of the spear. When I say unfortunately, it is kind of like the Battle of Thermopylae, and you got the big army right there, and you're right up front, you know, defeating them, but the arrows are coming at you. And as long as we win the war, I'm not really worried about what happens to me, but I'd like to see a lot of other folks, you know, more than 300 up here on the front line, quite frankly. But look at the effect we're having with targeted information warfare. And our swords and arrows poisoned with the truth. You're like, poison with the truth? Well, that's poison to these evil people. Like sunshine to vampires. And they are absolutely on their knees right now and are getting ready to false flag, you name it, to make themselves look like victims. You can smell it. You can see it. But I've been so busy skipping breaks, so busy not plugging things last week, that we had a massive expenditure this week in Philadelphia and other areas, and I've not been plugging, and so we are losing money right now. We were doing okay before and in the black, but the tank's getting down close to empty to be able to continue on safely and really intensify what we're doing. So you just need to go to InfoWarsStore.com. We have the best shortwave radios, the best non-GMO seeds, the best nutraceuticals, the best Hillary for prison shirts. We have the new Bill Clinton rape shirt. You want to trigger these people. This is designed to send them into total convulsions. Get the historic shirt now. We're the exclusive distributor of it. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com for the nutraceuticals. We're carrying a lot of great Oakley merchandise at very low prices as well, like backpacks, you name it. We have great optics, but we have specials on some of the nutraceuticals that are running as well. I also want to introduce Operation Sleeping Giant, InfoWars.com/giant. This is not a money bomb this year. This is a 28-hour, it says 24-hour, but we're going to do the next 4 hours after the next day. So 28-hour, we need to change that. That's my typo. 28-hour worldwide historic broadcast with special documentaries, live guests, our crew on the ground while Hillary's being coronated, or while Wednesday into Thursday, they battle to steal the nomination. And the folks battle to get it back out of the jaws of the tyrants, grabbing liberty out of the jaws of oppression, snatching victory out of the jaws of defeat. So we're launching Operation Sleeping Giant. And what it's going to be is discounts, fundraiser, things like that, to be able to, again, you see what we've done each year, how we've dedicated, that we're going to the next level, how we're going to take on the New World Order, how I have a historic plan that is absolutely guaranteed if you get motivated and take action to bring them down. We have the truth. We have history. When I say historic plan, I've studied the truth. I've studied people that have fought tyranny. I understand the spirit we're dealing with. This is spiritual. And I know where we're going. And it is true, just as the Bible says, and just as common sense shows, or just as you know a certain line of dogs is better at hunting, or a certain line of bloodhounds is better at sniffing out the trail. My family on both sides, right back to England, has always been involved in everything from the Magna Carta, quite frankly, to the invention of the stock exchange, to the kickoff of 1776, right through everything we've seen, right up until the Texas Revolution. I mean, starting it. On my mother's side, they came here. They're the people with basically directives from Andrew Jackson to start the whole operation. And so I am meant to do this. This is what I was born to do in this season, in this generation of my genetic background, and it's here. And it's all hitting on all cylinders. The dominoes are going, and history's happening, and the globalists know it, and they have horror in their eyes. Horror. So you have that history of resistance in you, even if you don't know it. And it's time for you to realize it and step into your destiny. So introducing Operation Sleeping Giant. Operation Sleeping Giant is a historic 28-hour broadcast to take place in the middle of Queen Hillary's coronation at the DNC on Wednesday, July 27th. And again, the page isn't finished yet. It's going to be really high-tech with a lot of interesting things on it. Live feeds, you name it, other feeds from our crew on the ground, so multiple channels. But it's InfoWars.com/giant. And I believe it's live now, so we can put it up. Hillary Clinton has stolen Democratic nomination from Bernie Sanders and is now more important than ever to push back the globalist takeover. During the 28-hour broadcast, InfoWars will also be fundraising one of the biggest sales in history of InfoWarsStore.com. And to kick off this announcement, we're giving you 10% off on all InfoWars Life nutraceuticals at InfoWarsLife.com. Visit InfoWarsLife.com/giant to see all the latest videos, news about Operation Sleeping Giant. You can see that history is happening right now. We're all in it. This is the time for the maximum effort. And I love this new conspiracy theory around the internet that I'm using a teleprompter. And people say, oh, look, you just read off a thing. Because people take the points I make that I'm not going off notes or whatever. And then they say, oh, look, he's reading a note. Yes, I wrote this last night. Because we're so busy, we should have been planning this a month ago. I was up here late last night with Anthony Gucciardi and others working on this and a lot more. But it's just funny that, you know, they say that these aren't my own words. I mean, you can come in here with a camera right now. There are no teleprompters in here. It's ridiculous. Teleprompters are so the globalists can program the slogans they want to have it across networks and across platforms, talking points. My talking points come from truth and justice and common sense and honor and a historical lens, which is a magnifier. If you look at things through your individual experiences, it's a rose-colored darkly. You look through the mainstream media, it's a scanner darkly. You look through history, your gut, your spirit, and asking God for guidance, it's not a darkly, but a magnifier, an expander, an enhancer. And that's what they're trying to keep you from realizing and activating your human potential, which I've only begun to do myself. We also, again, have the all-new Hillary for President t-shirts. A new version of those are in. I'm going to stop plugging, but the point is that we need to refuel the operation. Also support our local M&FM affiliates. That is totally critical as well. Now, let me tell you the clips that are coming up here. First off, Trump has bounced into the lead. That's CNN. He's way ahead of that. We have Wasserman Schultz and others now coming out in memos saying, we're the women, we're in charge, and we don't care if people vote. We're going to put Hillary in. This is our time. So it's a bizarre sex-based cult of women who just say, this is our time. I mean, I don't care if it's a man or a woman. You're not going to steal the popular vote and engage in all this activity. And then put this evil gangster woman in so you have a cult of women under you. Bitter, wicked women who want to start a bunch of wars. No, it's just not happening. And they're going to push, so we're going to get into that. We also have the powerful video that's on DrudgeReport.com. Bernie voters hate Hillary. Very powerful. We also have InfoWars launches Operation Sleeping Giant. Just talked about that. Media caught covering up major Islamic ties. I'm going to get into that. Only started to mention that. We've got so much to cover here that is so important. We've got Hillary saying she's a naturalized citizen. We have Bernie supporters absolutely waking up to what's happening. This is so big. I cannot stress that enough. But first, where do I stand on the Russians hacking the UN, hacking East Anglia 6 years ago, and proving that global warming is a worldwide plan to depopulate countries and turn off the power and consolidate control? And Putin's come out and said, we have their documents. It's a plan, a war against nation states. Well, I said that before Putin did, because that's what it is. It's not that me and Putin are reading from the same script. We can look out the window and see the sun, you know, the same sun come up. We can look up at the same constellation in the sky different times a day when it's dark and see Orion's belt. We can watch the same movie, True Grit, and see John Wayne. I mean, it's just we're seeing the same thing. It's what the document says. It's their battle plan. It's like reading Hitler's Mein Kampf. How do you know what Hitler thought? He told you. So, bravo. Plan to shut off all the Russians' power, shut off their oil and gas that they make their money off of, selling it to Europe. A plan to deindustrialize us as them. I mean, we're all in this together against the globalists. Bravo. And everything else they've been doing. Bravo. You'll know them by their fruits. Exposing Hillary, stealing the election. Exposing their criminal activity. Exposing her getting money from foreign powers. Thank God Russia's doing what our own captured government's doing. We have a captured government. The Russians have been captured by the oligarchs that were there for 85 years. They understand what it is to be under foreign control. that puts in a socialist system to suppress the people. We're going to skip this break. It's too important. This is history happening. So I don't lionize the Russians. They have their own set of problems. But they're not eugenicists now. They're paying people to have kids. They're exposing that there's attacks on the family. They're exposing that there's a globalist program to bring down civilization. They understand. They listen to this show. They don't need to listen to this show. They've got analysts looking at what's going on. They've been under it. And Donald Trump doesn't want to destroy nation states. He doesn't. He's not out to get Russia. He's not out to get anybody. I assure you, though, if Russia ever makes one move against the U.S., Donald Trump will smash those movements. The Russians won't do it. They understand. The Chinese, on the other hand, are going to come after Trump big time. You get ready. They've almost got this country captured. They're one of the big client groups, along with the Arabs, that are running the show in this country. And Israel's been playing both sides, trying to come out ahead, and that's not been working for Israel. The Israel lobby's starting to figure that out. You better figure it out. Quit being so arrogant. So, we're going down a really bad road if this doesn't get turned around, okay? The Russians aren't involved in our internal politics, if you notice what they how they say it. But they are watching groups that are involved in our politics. That's the foreign combines of banks, and they're exposing them. Just like British papers expose how the Rothschilds, every time they'd arrest an oligarch, they go, oh, sorry, the money's already out of the country. I'm a Rothschild front. Rothschilds sued them, saying that was a conspiracy theory. They lost in court. There were other oligarchs as well, but this is what's going on. This is the reality. So here they are in the media going, oh, we know it's the Russians. Well, for once, you know, a broken clock, you know, was right a couple times a day. Blind hogs can find acorns. Obviously, it is the Russians. Clinton campaign, plenty of evidence that Putin wants Trump to win election. Let's go ahead and play this clip.
Trump weighing in on WikiLeaks, no surprise, but what he is saying may surprise you. Put up the tweet, please. Wait for it. Wait for it. There it is. The new joke in town is that Russia leaked the disastrous DNC emails, which should never have been written, stupid, because Putin likes me. Brian Fallon shaking his head when we first looked at this tweet. You said he's wrong again. How?
Because there's a consensus among experts that it is indeed Russia behind this hack of the DNC. A couple months ago, when the hack was first reported, it was a former top FBI official, the person that used to run
cyber investigations. All right, let's just stop right there. Let's just stop right there. You know, here's the deal. Obviously, Trump doesn't know Russia's doing this. It's good for Trump to say that. He knows that it's too sophisticated of an argument to go through the fact that we're occupied by globalists. He's trying to explain that right now. And so we're trying to kick him out. And so these globalists are starting a war with Russia, too. They want to bring us all down to control us. They want us as slaves. And so Russia has interest to expose this. But when you say that, there's a lot of sophisticated groups over in Europe, period. And so Russia does become the kind of blame all. It doesn't matter. It's criminal activity of crooked Hillary coming out. That's what matters. Now, speaking of Trump, I mentioned this. Let me give you the numbers on this. We're going to get into the Islamists, the gun grab, and more. Trump bounces into the lead. CNN says he's 4 points ahead of Hillary. And in some polls, even 5 points. Business Insider, Nat Silver. Donald Trump would most likely win the election if it was held today. Of course he would, by 10 points in my educated deep view. A lot of folks are closeted. Cleveland bounce. Donald Trump surges to 44 with Hillary Clinton at 40. Obama's brother voting for Obama. Trump, Hillary VP pick is bought and owned by the banks. Absolutely. So that's some of the news on that front. Meanwhile, the leaked emails, again, just to recap this, show that they sent the people dressed in Bernie outfits, Bernie t-shirts, in places like Chicago and other areas to create a fissure between Trump people and Bernie people. It hasn't worked completely. And so we always knew that this was being directed, the violence, so they could act like Trump was bad. It backfired on him. It just shows the judgment of Hillary and these people. They don't understand that the world has changed and that they're not running these operations in 1980 or 1990. People are onto their tricks. And the fact that Schultz, in fact, I've got it here in the stack, said, we're women. We don't care what Bernie or who votes. Well, this is our time. I mean, these are bizarre, naked statements from last year. And it's their arrogance that's bringing them down. Remember the Republicans a few months ago going, it's normal. The popular votes never mattered. We're just going to appoint whoever we want. We are the sovereigns. Forget a mere plurality of the voters. The arrogance of George Will. These people all go into these globalist meetings and sit around and they're decaying. It was their fathers and grandfathers that took over America. They were corrupt and evil. They were the conquerors. But now the people that inherited it just sit around with their toupees on, like George Will. Nothing against his toupee. Just like a turtle shell on top of his head. And he just talks in a stuffed suit like he's an intellectual. And all he is a Benedict Arnold piece of filth. And the media made a big deal about the fact that if I said our votes don't count, we should just accept royalty over us. He said, sovereigns, they're the sovereign party. I don't wish any harm upon him. He's such a piece of trash. I said, you know, you ought to stick a gun in his mouth and blow his brains out the back of his head. He wants to rape us and hand us over to a dictatorship of the Republican Party? That's not an extreme statement to say, why don't you just kill yourself? All this royalty and people that say the Earth's too overpopulated and want to come back as a virus to kill us. And Ted Turner saying he wants us all to die and stuff. And we shouldn't have kids, but he's got five kids. Listen, bro, run a hot bath, get a straight razor and just get to work. Get to work. You got such a loathing for humanity. I love humanity. I love it so much that wild horses couldn't drag me away from this fight. And there have been moments in my life when I first confronted Bilderberg and other events where I knew I was crossing thresholds. And at this Cleveland event, the things that happened there that I'm not going to get into, some of the behind-the-scenes stuff, to realize that we've been influencing, that I knew the UKIP party from very early on massively, the Russian government, Trump, everything. I mean, for over a decade, we have been the counter talking point for the New World Order, along with DrudgeReport.com, who's magnified our work with the stories it links to. And that's not bragging. I thought about not even talking about this. I want you to understand the power you have. Because no matter what happens to Alex Jones, you're going to continue on in the fight. But, I mean, I'll be quite honest with you. To use a cheesy Star Wars analogy, I am in the trench, ladies and gentlemen. I am in the trench with the turbo lasers and the TIE fighters behind me. And all I care about is enough people get in the fight, get in the trench. They're not going to stop us all. Somebody's going to shoot torpedoes down the reactor shaft. So you need to understand this is history happening right now. Make no mistake. And I am focused on the target. Fire, fire, fire. You just got to turn loose with instinctive action and move against the New World Order. I was talking about this with some special forces guys. When they were talking about instinctive shooting, you're like, hey, remember when you were a kid, you'd have a .22 and a bird be flying, a dove. 60, 70 yards away. And if you didn't think, every time I'd just shoot it. But as soon as I learned to not do that and try, I'd miss it every time. So I'm not getting into the whole mumbo jumbo of the force and all of that, but that's an allegory for the basics of how powerful the human mind is. We have to decide we're going to win. We have to decide we're going to hit the target. We have to decide we're going to have the truth. We have to decide we're going to have the discernment. We're going to have to decide we've got the will and the courage to let the globalists know, you want to put your will on us? You want to try to dominate us? Feel our will and just ask God to work through you to have incredible strength. And it's happening now. The spirit of liberty is coursing out into the universe right now. The sleeping giant is rising. The battle is about to begin. Top story on DrudgeReport.com, burning hot, Hitlery. And the video of the Bernie supporters that absolutely hate her guts. And then we've got the video coming up. I'm going to play at the bottom of the hour, this video. We have James O'Keefe joining us, the one, the only, Project Veritas, with devastating video, talking to delegates. And we just ran into one of them again today, bragging about how they're going to get the guns, but they've got to use moderate language to fool people, but that she's talked to Hillary, and they're going to get the guns. Then we ran into her today. So O'Keefe did this, shot this a few days ago and put it out. Now we ran into her in real time, in live time. And it's amazing. They've even got cops assigned to this lady, I guess. Her name, the Clinton alternate delegate, Mary Bayer, told a Project Veritas reporter But they don't want to make everybody mad. I have to paraphrase what she said. There's a cuss word in it. And so they basically are hiding the truth from the public before they get into office. Look, we know you're coming for the guns. We know you're coming to sew the country up for tyranny. We know you want to put 4 to 5 Supreme Court justices in. You must be defeated. The good news is we went to California and other states, and we could not hardly, I mean, I'm talking 1 out of 10 on election day, 2 out of 10 saying they were for Hillary in exit polls. I mean, it was a total landslide. One of the biggest trouncings, one of the biggest repudiations of the establishment ever seen. And ladies and gentlemen, they found in major studies that exit polls are within 3% accurate. We sent Leanne McAdoo and others out to the exit polls. 2 out of 10 said they were for Hillary. And I thought that was a big story, but it got overshadowed when it came out in the New York Daily News. I can't believe I'm even saying this. It's so bombshell. I mean, we knew it was happening, but it was even in the news, and nothing happened. That they met at a rich person's house with CNN and AP, who runs the, quote, Voter News Services. And that they decided, talking to the superdelegates, what the numbers would be that night on TV. The election the next day meant nothing. And we knew that happened in other states like New Hampshire. But they did it in front of everyone. And then I said, who are these Democrats? Why would they ever throw out the elections in America and allow something like this to happen? Don't they understand the unprecedented peril? What comes next? And slowly it bubbled. The media kept saying, and I kind of still bought into it. I should know this, all lies. Like, oh, all the Bernie people agree now. They're not really mad. They're going to go for Hillary because they hate Trump. And I knew that was a talking point, but I thought they were jellyfish. I thought they wouldn't stand up. Again, Rob Deuce, separate reporter, he goes, I talked to almost 100 people and 80% are for Sanders inside the DNC area. On the street, there's demonstrations everywhere. Almost no one supporting Hillary. Folks, Bernie Sanders got 80% of the vote. Bernie Sanders, you can't ever, she'd have rallies and there'd be the maximum 2,000 or 3,000, usually 500, sometimes like 50 or 20. You saw the articles on Drudge and Daily Caller and Breitbart and InfoWars. We sent reporters all over the country. I mean, you don't have 20,000, 30,000 people, sometimes 50,000 at a Bernie Sanders event. I mean, race, color, and creed, and then Hillary's got 1,000 on average, and then she's winning. It's not true. It'd be like if you had a restaurant with, you know, one car at it in rush hour, and the other restaurant's got 100 cars. Which restaurant's got better food? You know which one when you drive into a town. Don't need to look at Yelp or TripAdvisor or, you know, some kind of restaurant, gastropod site. You look at the place with the most cars. From the titan of investigative journalists, ProjectVeritas.com's James O'Keefe. And he's got them in a stranglehold. His organization brought down Akron and has brought down so many other criminal operations. They've tried to put him in prison. They have attacked him. They've done a lot of things he doesn't even want to get into. Why talk about what the enemy's doing? We talk about what we're up to. And he's a hero, and he's there in Philadelphia. He joins us till the bottom of the hour. Just a few days ago, and the video's gone up exclusively at InfoWars.com and ProjectVeritas.com. Clinton delegate explains how Democrats will ban all guns. Democrat operative says Hillary would support total gun ban, that she's met with her, that's the plan, and that they don't want to scare the public. And the full video is up on InfoWars.com. They're in a bar, a restaurant. They're talking to her. This woman has a police escort. She's a Hillary alternate. This is really, really creepy, but they're being more honest now in Rolling Stone, The Washington Post, saying it's time to ban the Second Amendment, it's time to repeal it. But then our reporters, we're going to play this in a few minutes, this was 2 hours ago, they ran into people confronting her already from InfoWars and Project Veritas when this article went up at 7 a.m. this morning. 7 a.m. this morning, within a few hours, she was already being confronted. And I'm going to talk to James O'Keefe about the bombshell. 8 out of 10 people we talked to on the street and inside say they're not for Hillary and that there's going to be a revolt They're booing Wasserman Schultz. She's having to resign. This is epic. This is so historic. Trump is surging in all the polls. James O'Keefe, let's go over this event, what happened, and then we'll play the latest confrontation. James O'Keefe, Project Veritas.
Hey, thanks, Alex. As you can see, I'm wearing a shirt. It says, I am secretly recording you right now because I'm in Pennsylvania, which is a two-party consent state to tape. We got a Hillary delegate on a hidden camera saying that she wanted to ban all guns, but she has to lie about her intention. She has to say it's common sense gun legislation. And she says, quote, if you just say expletive like that, people will buy into it, unquote. That's what the Hillary delegate said. She didn't know she was being taped. Now we confronted her here in Philadelphia and got her unbelievable reaction. She grabbed this sign here, which is a quote from the video, and she grabbed it and she ran away as police officers chased her. And you guys have that video as well.
We're going to play that stunning video in a moment. Of course, this is so fitting, sir, that George Washington is behind you, at, standing in front of Independence Hall, radiating out liberty with his hand stretched forward, like his hand is on the nation right now, as Philadelphia is infested with the establishment scum of the earth.
Well, I mean, it's incredible, and we are here in Philadelphia, and that is George Washington. He's pointing right at the camera, actually. But what's remarkable is in this video is how honest they are and how she just basically said, we have to lie to the public. We have to mislead the public. Here's how we do a bait and switch. Those are her words, bait and switch. And she was so shocked that we caught up with her this morning. I mean, she came outside the hotel. The hotel kicked us out. Everyone in there is filming. All the media is filming. Of course, they kicked me out, because I'm the one filming. They don't like the fact that I'm filming. And I've got my shirt on. I've got a camera here. Everyone can see me. But they kicked me out. And then she came out of the hotel, grabbed the sign, ran back in, and started crying. This is a Hillary delegate on video today. So it is. It's just launched. It's going around. And we're calling it hashtag to catch a delegate.
Like, and her name is Mary Bayer. And by the way, that's a great hashtag. But I want to create a new one that names Project Veritas in our story at InfoWars. I want to create a new one. You're better at this than I am sometimes. What's the tagline to call her the new Gruber discovered? Because
that's
remember,
right.
Gruber it's, said, thank God they're all so dumb. We got to sneak it through. I'm going to double and triple their prices. He
right.
loves me. I'm the best liar. And then he
it
said,
is
oh,
very
that-
Gruber. It is very Gruber-like. The new Gruber or something like that. Her name is Mary Bayer. She's a Hillary delegate.
How about, how about Mary Bayer Gruber is the hashtag?
Mary Bayer Gruber. That's the hashtag on Twitter.
I'm sorry. This is just so epic. I mean, you are literally devastating the enemy right now. Please continue.
Yeah. So we have this video. We just confronted her. She's actually texting me. This is Mary Bayer. She just texted me moments before I came on here. And she's like, you seem like such a nice guy. I thought you were there. So
yeah, back off. We just want to steal the election and take your guns, sweetheart. Why don't you let us sneak through your window at night like vampires and drink your kids' blood?
And as we were walking out of the hotel and people saw we were Project Veritas, not everyone here dislikes us. We had a number of Bernie supporters come up. One of the African-American Bernie supporter came up to me and said, you know, Hillary people actually said racial slurs to us. They said, quote, just go back to where you came from. So this is just a total circus here.
Well, that's my experience. That's key. And I don't just say this. Growing up in a Republican family, I mean, we were Christians. We were taught white people had done bad things, but that abolitionists were trying to fix it, and we had to try to be a good society. And then I would get around Democrats in my life, in the East, but also in Texas. And when they close the door, man, they are like KKK members. Sorry, go ahead.
No, that's exactly right. And when we go behind closed doors, like we did with Mary Bayer in that bar in California, they admit to us exactly what their intentions are. And again, the quote is, you got to say you want common sense gun legislation. You say blank like that, and people will buy into it, unquote. You can, quote, bait and switch them. This is what this California delegate says. So we're about to go back to the California delegation and ask each and every one of them, is she going to continue to be a delegate? Do you stand behind these comments? We tried to do that. We got kicked out of the hotel. We're going to go back in.
Unbelievable. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we've got to put out the hashtag Mary Bayer Gruber.
Gruber.
And then explain that link to the fact that she is the new Gruber. And we can have memes of Gruber saying, thank God the American people don't have a good attention span. I was hired to lie and then have her quotes about we've got to bait and switch them, but Hillary does plan to ban all the guns. These are quotes.
This seems to be a common theme. This is a common theme with all of our videos where they lie to the American people. Just be honest. Say what you're going to do. If this is what you want to do.
These are rat-like scum. I mean, these people are scum.
Well, all you got to do is be honest about it. It's fine to be scum. Just say, hey, I'm going to ban all guns and here's what I'm going to do. But instead, common sense gun legislation. But if we finally have the admission, so now we're going to spend the rest of the day. I probably have hours of video. I'm probably going to get assaulted. I might even get detained. But I'm going to ask everyone if they agree with this or not.
Sure. Do you mind if we embed one of our reporters with you?
Sure. I think a couple of you guys are here standing over there. That's great. I think we got a convention pass, and we're going to try to get into the building.
We've got some, too, as well. I mean, I know you're with one of our crews right now, but I mean, just unbelievable. I'm sorry if I gush sometimes, just all the victories you have. It's an example for everybody, and I just want to defeat these people. Do you think I'm exaggerating when I say I think there's going to be a giant revolt? They're already revolting. Almost everyone we talk to, our reporters say, is actually hate Hillary. They see through it. We have video of this. It's collapsing. These emails have come out showing they plan to steal it, to send their people dressed as Bernie people to the Trump rallies. I mean, they've been caught. This is incredible.
Yeah, the WikiLeaks thing happened over the weekend. So whereas the WikiLeaks focused on the emails, and in those emails you see the collusion, there's actually an admission in one of those emails, by the way, that they should deceptively edit video of Trump. If my team ever said, first of all, we never said that. But they were caught saying we should deceptively edit video. There's a collusion. A political reporter was pre-screening his emails by the DNC. So there's a collusion with NBC, CBS, ABC News, with the DNC. That's why no one's reporting on that scandal. So whereas WikiLeaks released emails, we are releasing video. This is not just email. This is video from inside the DNC delegation describing how they're going to sell crap to the American public and how they're going to frame it. It's on video, folks. It's right there. So now you just got to put pressure on these people and say, do you or do you not condone this?
Project Veritas leader James O'Keefe is our guest. The articles are on Infowars.com. They're also on the Project Veritas website. Everyone needs to go there, ProjectVeritas.com, and get the video and the article out to everyone. Bottom line, Hillary operative caught saying they're going to bait and switch American people, that she plans to ban guns, close quote, a devastating victory because it shows the evil. This is the new Gruber. We have the new Gruber. We have her now. And the other delegates are just as arrogant. We talked to the one saying, oh, it doesn't matter. I'm a super delegate. It doesn't matter how you vote. Hillary's going to get in. You know, we had that guy in New Hampshire. We need to now get all this video back out to the public, new and old, to expose just how arrogant. I believe they've jumped the shark, Mr. O'Keefe. I think we're seeing the fall of the system right now.
I think you're seeing a slow revolt. I'm going to have more to report on today because we're walking around. But I think this WikiLeaks thing, Debbie Wasserman Schultz is out. I think people are fed up. And what's happening behind closed doors, we're getting it on tape now. We got the emails and we have the video. So this is the beginning. This is a tipping point today. And I ran into Tom Brokaw. He saw the video. I mean, we're on the front lines here. So we're going to have a lot more to report.
Let's think about how viral this is going. It was posted this morning, and you saw Tom Brokaw, and he'd already seen it. People are already confronting her. When we come back, I want to play that clip because you're with us for another 10 minutes till 30 after, James. And I want also, if you can, with our camera crew, to walk over beneath George Washington, if we can, with Independence Hall right behind you, because I want George Washington right there beside you, because I tell you, you're a modern George Washington, a modern Paul Revere, and everybody out there doing what James is doing. More and more citizen journalists have read his book. More and more people are taking action, and we're seeing this everywhere, where we've got eyes and ears everywhere, and their arrogance is bringing them down.
That's right. We got eyes and ears everywhere, and if you're stealing, lying, or cheating, or misleading the public, we will find you, we will film you, and we will make you an internet sensation, which is what Mary Bayer Gruber, that's the new hashtag, the new Jonathan Gruber, Mary Bayer Gruber, has been caught on tape scheming and doing.
And I'm sorry, she is a villain about how they're conning people and how they're going to rob us of our rights that the country was founded when they came to take the guns. And they just are so arrogant, and their arrogance is coming to an end. What is it about traitors that they're always so arrogant, think they're invincible?
There's nothing wrong with being that way. You just got to be honest about it. I'm just asking people to be straightforward about their views. And that's what we're getting on tape doing.
James, we're going to come right back with the man behind Project Veritas. Straight ahead, I'm Alex Jones with InfoWars.com. James O'Keefe is our guest. I want to play a few minutes of video with our reporters today running into Clinton delegate Mary Bayer Gruber. And this is Mary Bayer is her real name, but Gruber, because she thinks we're all dumb and idiots and she has to deceive us to get our guns, and Hillary will get our guns. Let's play part of this clip. Here it is.
It's on YouTube. It's on Alex Jones right now.
Who is Alex Jones?
He's a journalist, and I'm James O'Keefe on the Project Veritas.
And so can you explain to me what your point, the goal of your organization
is? It's to expose the truth and expose lies and corruption from people
so
like you.
So you're saying I told a lie?
You did. It's on video.
What is my lie?
You said, quote, you got to say you want common sense gun legislation. You say like that, and people buy it.
Well, what did somebody say to me? You say that? Wait, was this like 4 years ago or something?
He said, how do you ban guns? And you explained how to do it.
You got to report it.
Reporters there tried to ask her a question, so they had to go. And then I guess I'll keep saying they've got more video that's going to be coming where she grabs the sign and runs off. Correct me if I'm wrong, but there's James O'Keefe with one of our reporters picking it up on tape. This is just amazing. James, what else does she do?
Well, she came outside. That's the first video we sent to you. We airdropped it to one of your producers here. But she came outside, and she grabbed the sign. This is the sign here with her quote on it from the video where she describes how she's going to ban all the guns and mislead the people. And she goes into the building, runs in the convenience store, and starts crying. And I'm chasing after her because she's got my sign. I'm trying to get my sign back. And the police are chasing after her. And she goes into this corner of the convenience store, starts crying. She cannot believe she was caught on videotape. She does not believe this.
So she wants to steal our guns. Now she steals your sign as if somehow that will hide what she's done. I can't wait to see this footage. We didn't get it in the airdrop yet. Please try to resend it. We're going to do a big story on this, James.
We will definitely get it to you. And then the Marriott, there's like thousands of journalists, hundreds of journalists inside this Marriott, and they're all filming. And the law enforcement people are like, all right, so you can't film in here. Well, everyone's filming in there, but we can't film in there. She's stealing my sign. It's just a crazy series of events. And then after the convenience store, Tom Brokaw walks over and looks at the video. So we're starting to get people's attention. And this woman, Mary Bayer, and you said Mary Bayer, what was your hashtag, Alex?
Mary Bayer Gruber.
Gruber, because she's the new John Gruber, because John...
That's right. In fact, let's do a hashtag that says New John Gruber Discovered, and then we'll have the other one too. But New John Gruber, New John Gruber, and then Mary Bayer Gruber.
Yeah, so she's texting me, this Mary Bayer delegate, my cell phone, and she's saying, you seem like such a nice guy. I didn't...
How did she get your cell phone?
Well, I had to get her down to the lobby, so we called her and said, hey, you know, we'd like to ask you a few questions. So she called back, and now she's texting. So she's shocked. She's in a state of shock about the fact that she was caught on this video.
Let me ask you a question. Why do you think the police tend to sit there? Because I had the Young Turks physically attack me, spit in my face after one of their people invited me up. Then the guys were screaming off camera like he's one of my people. We've now figured out what they were doing, making a disturbance. That's the same guy that runs around and spits in my face. And then they called the cops and said I did something to them, that I'd physically done something. The cops told me. And I told the cops, no, they're lying. Look, I've been spit on. They said, okay, do you want us to press charges? And I said, no. And then they start bringing our YouTube videos down because they were on the YouTube set. I mean, this is crazy.
It is crazy. I mean, the police are pretty good. I mean, they were trying to, I mean, this individual, Mary Bayer, was going nuts. She was walking into the convenience.
No, I understand they chased her down the second time.
They chased her in there. They tried to get the sign. And then they said, sir, we're trying to deal with the situation. And then the hotel security kicked us out, said, you can't film in here. Everyone is filming inside that hotel. Everyone. And I even have a shirt. As I said before, Alex, I'm in Pennsylvania. It's a two-party consent state to film. It says, I am recording you right now. So everyone has the consent required to film. But we are going to go back, Alex, to that hotel. We are going to go back to the California delegation with this sign and ask for comment from every single individual.
ProjectVeritas.com, James O'Keefe. We're going after the break, after I play these folks that are against Hillary, these Bernie supporters, this viral video that Drudge has as his top story at drudgereport.com. We're going to play that, and then I'm going to go to my crew, David Knight and others, inside the convention. But I would love later to see you go down Media Row, because I predict someone in Media Row, I predict if they see James O'Keefe is going to flip out, they're so scared of you. What do you think?
I absolutely will do that. I've got a pass from one of the guys here, gave one to me, and I'm going to walk around all day like this. I promise you, people are going to freak out. This will be one person I talk to.
You're amazing. James O'Keefe, we're going to be following you. Let's go into the convention with you. God bless you. We'll be talking to you soon, sir.
Thanks.
Wow, James O'Keefe, I've talked to him all week long. Amazing. Amazing. Stay with us. All right, very exciting time. We're in the next 5-10 minutes. We're going to be connecting with David Knight and the rest of the crew inside the DNC. And we are basically chronicling the major revolt that is already taking place. Also, we're going to be going up and down Media Row, also getting information out to the public. We're talking to people outside. That's where the really important stuff is going on in many cases. And we're going to be here live for 28 hours live starting Wednesday morning at 11 a.m. Central, 12 noon Eastern, right through the supposed coronation, the battle. They're going to try tonight. So the InfoWars Nightly News is going to be so important to just get the delegate thing out of the way and certify it and clamp it down and act like it's no big deal. But then all hell's going to break loose. And then you're just going to see more happen over the next few days. This is a big, big deal. So the 28-hour Operation Awaken the Sleeping Giant is launching. And we have a countdown at Infowars.com/giant. We're going to have crew on the ground. We're going to be working out of all these studios, Watson out of the London studios, and more. And it's not a money bomb. It is basically something that's even more effective. It's a big sale fundraiser. And you can obviously see what we do every single year, how we are exponentially, logarithmically, just growing and engaging the globalists. There is no media outlet in the world other than drudgereport.com that has a small operation that reaches this many people. And that's why you see the Federal Elections Commission and others licking their chops, wanting to go after free speech and admitting it. They're not just going after the Second Amendment. They're going, I've got stacks of news here about the attack on the internet, Bloomberg News, China bans internet news reporting, just internet news reporting, period, as media crackdown widens. You just can't report news even if they agree with it. Law is suspended. Turkish lawyers report abuse of coup detainees, massive torture. China internet regulator fines website over reporting. This is happening in Europe as well with the jihadis. Turkey targets media, new crackdown. What do you think it is when the BBC and all the rest of the media suddenly won't say terrorist, or the guy's named Ali, they won't show his name? They say his name's David. Why not just say, you know, that David Jones did it? Why not just say that the Easter Bunny did it? We also have a story Paul Watson wrote about it up on InfoWars.com that deals with all of that. If they stole the election and have almost completed that from Bernie Sanders, then what are they willing to do in the general election? If they're going to rob one bank, would they rob two? Because they've already been caught. They're on the run, basically. Backs against the wall. They'd rob two. They'd rob three. They'd rob four. They'd rob five. Because if she gets into office, Katie, bar the door. Get ready. Drums from the deep. They're coming. Drums. Wow. The only hope we have, and it's a big hope, it's a sure hope if we take action, is to just hit them with everything we've got. Call them out for the crooked Hillary she is. Trump has led the way as the nominee to call her a criminal, to expose world government, to expose she's a Chinese agent. He's made it safe for everybody else to do what I've been doing forever, hitting the barbed wire. We are the shock troops. We've done our job. Now everybody else got to come to the breach with us, and we're going to take this sucker down and restore the republic. We got to bring down the world government because it's meant to bring us down, fundamentally. Now, we are running some specials at InfoWarsStore.com. Part of this Operation Sleeping Giant is 10% off. across the board, InfoWars Life, on the nutraceuticals. We have an all-new Hillary for President t-shirt, third generation out. That is literally on the verge of selling out. And then there's going to be Generation 4, which probably will be the last generation because the election will be over by then, and we'll see which way it goes. Then it'll be, the impeach Hillary shirt, or who knows, we'll even be around then. I mean, this is kind of make it or break it time, isn't it? That's why we're all in. And then we have the new Hillary whole election derailing rape shirt. Bill Clinton smiling. Looks like an Obama hope posterized communist shirt. And it says rape on it. And boy, it's hard to get attention everywhere. You want to trigger one of these idiots, get it. It's now available at InfoWarsStore.com or call toll free 888-253-3139. And of course, they're just going to be shipping out Wednesday. The truck manufacturing them is almost here. It's that new of a shirt. Won't be shipping out till later in the week. InfoWarsStore.com or call toll free 888-253-3139. Okay, where to begin here, ladies and gentlemen? Where to start? We're about to go to our reporters here in a few minutes, but first, let's go to drudgereport.com, at least earlier. I don't have it up right now. It was an image of Hillary Clinton, and it's still there, burning hot. And you click on the story, and you see an InfoWars story, Bernie voters hate Hillary. Proof Trump can win in November, Hillary splitting her own base. It's beyond that. I mean, almost every Hillary supporter we run into can hardly talk. They're a very small minority there, be they black or white. There's a huge contingent of communist Chinese operatives, obviously, there. And you've got mad populist people, a lot of them saying they're going to vote for Trump. Or they're saying they're going to vote for a third-party person. Why would you throw your vote away? I always want to build a third party whenever there's not a choice. I mean, when it's McCain versus Obama, I said vote third party. I was kind of stupid because McCain was the alternate for Obama. He was just the stand-in, like somebody, as I've said before, in a Don King boxing match. But I tell you, now there is no choice here. Do not vote Gary Johnson. Do not vote other parties. Vote Donald Trump or you are insane. And I've been canvassing Democrats I know, the ones that are somewhat intelligent, and all of them are saying, I'm not going to vote for Hillary, even though they're in Texas. They say, what's the point, though, because she's going to take Texas. She might cheat and say she won Texas. That's how evil and over the top she is. You got to vote no matter where you are. It's all going to be very, very effective as a statement as well. But the Democrats I talk to are not voting for Hillary. I mean, I don't know where they are. So let's go ahead and go to this report that is, again, on InfoWars.com.
My message is to Hillary Clinton, drop out. You have made a mockery of our democracy.
She's not a progressive candidate, and I don't intend to vote for her in November. I'll be voting for Jill Stein if the Democratic establishment has their way and proceeds with the coronation of Hillary, despite the will of the people being behind Bernie Sanders.
How would you describe Hillary in your own words?
I think I'll go with Donald Trump's on this one. She's crooked.
She's part of the Clinton crime family, and she needs to be put in prison right away. What her and Debbie Wasserman Schultz did to all of the voters in this country is unfathomable. They haven't put her in jail yet.
Hillary Clinton's followers have no problem, and they have denied election fraud.
Hillary Clinton is in a syndicate that is controlling or attempting to control all of our government, and no one seems to care about it. I care. I'm outraged. I want to defend my right to vote. I don't want government corruption.
She's the picture of corruption.
I mean, you're probably about the first person I've interviewed today said the same thing.
Well, I mean, she's been corrupt since 92?
Yeah.
When Bill was elected? And now it's just getting that much worse. I mean, she made, what, $21 million from speaking to different banks and Wall Streeters?
Yeah. Well, do you think a lot of those, quote, speaking fees were kickbacks for deals?
I think anyone who doesn't is naive.
Now listen, Hillary Clinton, I didn't vote for you in 08. I voted for Obama because he wasn't you. You know what? You're a liar. You're a cheat. We don't raise our children to act this way. And you're going to further it? You got super delegates that you bought before the election? I'm in Michigan, Hillary. We uncrowned you, you fracking queen. And I'm going to tell you what. All your super delegates that are standing behind you in Michigan, the finger isn't on them when it comes August and November to vote. We're voting you out. We're going for a new Congress. You don't win anything because we're not going away. Our job is just beginning, and our job is to shut you down. F you, Hillary Clinton.
And all day I've noticed a disconnect between Bernie supporters and Hillary Clinton. I've interviewed probably nearly a dozen people so far at several different protests. I had not one of them told me they were going to vote for Hillary.
No. I haven't found, the only Hillary supporters I've found here is CNN. CNN, and that's, I probably shouldn't say that, that's kind of mean, actually. But I haven't run into any Hillary supporters either.
What do you think about Hillary Clinton's support for TPP?
I think it's phony. Basically, she called it the Gold Rule of Trade Agreements. And now, during the campaign, she flip-flopped to try to keep up with Bernie Sanders. She'll pass it. They're going to try to pass it through after November between her and then. If they don't pass it then, I'm sure she's going to make a good excuse to pass it. I don't trust her. I'm not voting for her. Simple as that. I'm not voting for a corporation.
Hillary cheats. Now, the last couple of weeks, she's not up in double digits against Trump. She's into 2 or 4 points.
Or losing.
She is losing in swing states, which has not happened in decades.
They'll support Jill Stein. Some of them might go to Gary Johnson, some might go to Stein, but I would say 80% of them are not voting for Hillary.
If they want to anoint that little effing whatever she is, we're going to lose to Trump, and it's on them. The games that they played and what they have done to us, good luck in November. You don't have our vote, you don't have our money, and Trump's going to flatten you like a pancake, Hillary.
Unbelievable truth. And I've got to say it, those are the Democrats I always knew that were on fire, smart, knew what was going on. I disagreed with the wealth redistribution, but I could get their points. Because the globalists are always able to screw over a capitalist system and corrupt it. They can just corrupt socialism even worse. That's the Democrats I've grown up around. And the kind of people that, you know, when I was on the air 18, 19 years ago, that people would say I was a liberal sometimes because I liked a lot of them. But you run into other Democrats. We're going to play this later. The only ones we found, you have to understand that liked Hillary are like zombies. Okay? I mean, I'm not kidding. We didn't just go find people go, oh, you're showing a mentally ill person. No. They're either like weird criminal managers who are real snake-like, or they're just these victims, these Renfields, you know, that follow the vampires around. And this is all archetypal, folks. They're like Igor or something. And that's why that's in all that literature, is the minion of the crook. He's like, just a little stupid gremlin or something. And it's scary when you're out there with them. You're like, my God, these people are dangerous. Now, David Knight is in the convention, an amazing shot via Skype inside for Infowars.com. David, I don't think I've ever seen such epic developments across the board with everything that's happening. I mean, even if they steal this today and tomorrow, they hope to shut down this rebellion. It's so massive, we can find no one. I mean, like 80% literally do not support Hillary outside or more. This is going to be huge. David, what do you think is happening right now?
David Knight from Infowars.com here at the 2016 Democrat National Convention. Alex, you're absolutely right. That report that you just played from Kit Daniels, who, by the way, is on the other side of this camera, shows that what they've got going on here is a grassroots rebellion that never developed at the GOP convention. They tried to push that narrative. They said there was going to be a walkout. And the people who are protesting outside the GOP convention were people that were Democrats. But this is an internal protest. And what we've seen happen with these email leaks this last week, I think, is epic. This is like the Snowden leaks, what they showed us about the NSA. We'd had NSA whistleblowers for quite some time. We'd been talking about it. Others had been talking about what was going on with dragnet surveillance of the American people. But it wasn't until we got the actual documents from Ed Snowden that it really put put it to the ground. And that's what we're seeing here at the Democrat convention. Everybody knew this was rigged. Everybody was talking about all the rigging that was going on. But now they see it. And I think, Alex, one of the things that's key is they now see the fact that it's not only the Democrat National Committee that was working with Hillary against Bernie Sanders, but it's also the mainstream media. The collusion between people at Politico sending her articles before they get published for approval. The idea that the Washington Post would hold fundraisers for her even after the DNC lawyer said, hey, that's not exactly legal.
Yeah, she sends out the talking points. She's above the law, and all of this collusion does is add incendiary to the fire. I mean, I think they're arrogant. I think they're miscalculating, David.
Well, I tell you what, I think Bernie Sanders miscalculated. We all did. We all groaned when he said, I'm tired of hearing about those damn emails. Well, I bet he's not tired of hearing about the damn emails now. His supporters certainly aren't. Even if he is okay with this, if he's going to play around with this and go along with what's happening, his supporters
are he's not going to be able to suppress his voters. If he dies, they're going to get mad at him, too. They should vote for Trump.
That's right. Well, one of the things that they're talking about, of course, Hillary's press is talking about how pleased Wall Street is with her pick for Vice President, Kaine. They're talking about how all these bankers are coming down to the convention here from New York. And, you know, Alex, I think we probably got more bankers here than they did at Bilderberg, circling Hillary, seeing what they can get from these people. And that's the key. That's the other thing that's getting the people who supported Bernie Sanders very upset. And that is the fact that, you know, Hillary was against, was for TPP before she was against it. And then she picked Kaine, who is for it in every regard. So,
sure, let me ask you this question. Levels. My gut tells me, and I've asked people and they say it, that as soon as you talk to a Democrat, they go, who are you really voting for? It's okay. I won't tell. They go, I'm going to vote for Trump because he's better on trade and the outside, you know, is against him. And I don't want to throw my vote away. So when we talk to these folks, most of them say they're going to vote for a third-party candidate. But I bet you when they get a twinkle in their eye when they say the word Trump, that most of them are going to go Trump.
Well, you know, Alex, if they don't want TPP, they're not going to have a choice except for Trump in most states. Jill Stein is the only other candidate besides Trump who said she's come out against that. She's not on very many ballots. And Gary Johnson is totally for it. So when you look at a lot of these issues, they're not going to have, if they're issue-based, the issues that they say are
absolutely.
Important to them.
I mean, look, if you vote for Gary Johnson, you might as well jump off a cliff, okay? Stay there, David. I'll come right back with you and more. And then in the third hour, I'm going to open the phones up. Then Leanne McAdoo's coming up. Stay with us. David Knight is joining us in this segment and into the next, maybe even a little bit longer. We're going to be taking your phone calls, 800-259-9231, on anything happening, on the Project Veritas info, on the delegates rebelling, on the hacked emails. There is so much going on, so much happening, so much unfolding. 800-259-9231. I'd especially like to hear from Bernie people. After all this came out, I gotta say Roger Stone was right again. It's in there that they sent people to do the Trump protests, had them dress up like Bernie folks. That's in the emails, but the media is not focusing on that. But they know that more of it's coming out as the real media looks at it. So she's, quote, stepped down to now work for Hillary as if she didn't always work for Hillary. David, what do you expect to happen? Do they have any chance at blocking these superdelegates because they're just stealing it? And does that really matter? Because the fact that they're stealing it will let everybody know that we now officially have had her coronated and the election suspended. So then if she tries to steal it from Trump, I don't see that working. I mean, I can tell you the big news.
I don't think there's going to be rebellion here, Alex, except from the grassroots. I don't think Bernie is going to have the guts to lead that. I think he's going to play nice. But the grassroots are very upset about this. You know, I saw a sign that said that Hillary is the Lance Armstrong of politics.
She's the new Lance Armstrong. We need to put that out. Hillary is the new Lance Armstrong at Infowars.com. We need a story saying that.
Except she's playing us for the dopes, and, you know, and her steroids are the Wall Street bankers that are financing her. And
well, I think Lance Armstrong didn't try to steal our guns, though. He didn't try to steal our elections. He just cheated like everybody else did.
That's right. You know, it's interesting, too, when we look at this, there's another doping scandal that's going on. Of course, that's the Russian doping scandal. But, you know, they're supposed to remove all the Russians from the Olympics because of a doping scandal. But it's no problem for Hillary because no matter what she does, she sails through. There's absolutely no accountability for her with any of this.
Let me ask you this. What does your gut tell you if she steals the nomination, steals the election? We know Trump's way ahead. I can tell you the Trump people are meeting. I can tell you the highest levels know she's going to try to steal. I'm just going to leave it at that. And that they've got plans to block it. Just like they blocked the Republicans from stealing it. Trump knows what he's doing. What do you expect to happen, though, if she was able to steal it? She'll be such a dead duck politically, everyone will know she's a dictator.
Yeah, I know, but everybody knew that Bill Clinton was a dictator, and he was able to get away with a lot. You know, we go back to that report that I talked about, Bill breaking the glass ceiling, but for banks, not for women.
No, I know. I mean, I know, but Clinton really got elected, though. Clinton really got elected. I mean, we have a lady who was installed as the nominee. That means she's a fraudulent president.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely a criminal. And I think it's interesting, Alex, when we look at the way they're trying to distract and muddy the water, you know, with the idea that this is about the Russians. Well, if the Russians are the ones that are doing this, don't you think the Russians were able to get her secrets as well? They don't want to talk about that. They would never talk about the fact that the FBI director said, yeah, the secure emails, the top secret emails that got off of her unsecured server, we have to assume that went into a lot of people.
And of course, you know, David, that the more is going to come whoever hacked this show. Maybe that's about to get released. The 33,000 she deleted. Oh, the Russians are like, oh, sorry, we have a copy of that for you.
You know, it's interesting you said that, Alex, because that was one of the things I was going to say. Wayne Madsen, as we're over here, got a phone call from one of his sources in Washington, said there are a lot more documents that are about to be released.
Well, that's our intel as well. Yeah. Oh, how horrible. The Russians exposed the UN plan to carbon tax and kill billions. Oh, they're horrible. We'll be right back, David Knight, in 70 seconds. He's inside the convention hall. You can see the free feeds at Infowars.com/show. Want to bring in a world government and cut off more than 80% of the energy in the next 30 years? It'll kill billions. That's a conservative number. They had top scientists come out, demographers look at it. You want to try to break up families and poison people and dumb everybody down and replace everybody with robots, and you think you're going to merge the machines and play God, and you're going to cancel our elections and install yourselves and run around doing everything but riding on broomsticks? We're going to come after you. And just people all over the world. Whether it's Donald Trump or David Knight, or whether it's Sally Soccer Mom out there, or whether it's the Russians. I mean, you try to bring in a worldwide tyranny, you code over it with a bunch of fancy garbage, doesn't matter. You write white papers about your plan. So we've read those, and we know how horrible it is. And so, of course, people are hacking you. Whether it's people inside the U.S. government or the Russians, whether it's Snowden or the Russians or whoever. We're hacking you on the street legally and lawfully. What do you make of this delegate that we've caught, Project Veritas, and we caught her on the street again, just saying, oh, yeah, we bait and switch, we hide it from the public, she plans to ban the guns. Sensational.
Yeah, Alex, that's exactly what the documents are saying. And that's the key thing. You know, we can show reports. We know what's going on. We get testimony from people. A lot of it is dismissed as sour grapes until we get the kind of report that O'Keefe had, until we get the documents that have just been released by the DNC. That's what I was saying about Snowden. When we got the Snowden leaks, that made it all real for people. And I think that it's becoming real for everybody except the faithful followers here in this area here. No matter what she does, they are going to cheer her on because they're not concerned about anything. But the rest of the country is starting to understand. They're starting to understand and see the reality of what this is, just like they did with the Snowden leaks. And I think it's interesting, when we look at the Snowden leaks, what was he telling us? He was telling us that our country, our government, was spying on Americans. And yet our government is not concerned about real secrets that are being leaked by this person who was not even qualified to have security access, security clearance. It was Bill Clinton's CIA director who was facing jail time before Clinton pardoned him for doing exactly the same thing, but on a much, much, much smaller scale than Hillary Clinton did, having classified documents on his unsecured laptop. And he lost his security clearance. He didn't go to jail only because he was pardoned by Bill Clinton. But these people around here just said everything that happens is simply a distraction to them from their worship of Hillary Clinton.
There's a lot of other things happening. What else are you focusing on? What else do we need to know about?
Well, Alex, you know, I think when we look at what's going on, maybe we ought to start looking around here, see if we can identify some of the bankers and bigwigs that we saw, you know, as we used to do that at Bilderberg.
That's right, handlers. Let's show who's actually up on top, who's actually pulling the strings.
Yeah. And tonight what we're going to have is, I looked at the speaker lineup. Most of the people who are going to be speaking are people who are dreamers, or you've got somebody who was an anchor baby, concerned that her parents are going to be deported. That's the lineup that they've got coming up. Then you've got Bernie Sanders, who's going to talk. And that's going to be a key right there as to whether or not people are going to walk out of this convention in protest. I think they basically have already pretty much consolidated things just to the Hillary Clinton people. But that'll be one thing for us to watch tonight. But then they're going to close it with Michelle Obama giving a happy unity type of speech. That's going to be the anchor speaker for tonight.
All right, David, one thing I want you to do is do a report. Go around and talk to delegates and say, so are you going to go with the votes that were for Bernie or the super delegates like in California just ignoring the election, and just get them to admit that, because it's important to show the disconnect with these people, and ask them if they're aware of this delegate, the new Gruber, who is saying, I talked to Hillary, we're going to ban the guns, but we've got to bait and switch these people. I mean, I really think that's important. And I also want to get your take on, get their take on the emails as well. But I want to come back with you. And I've got a few other questions for you, and just get your view on what you've seen outside and what you expect those demonstrations to be like. And we're going to take a few phone calls and cover some other news. So thank you, David Knight. Stay right there. I'm Alex Jones. Infowars.com. PrisonPlanet.com is the backup site. And the way the globalists want to get rich is not by innovation, not by actually developing systems and technologies and then building humanity up. No, no, no. They want to take control, have a post-industrial world, make everyone as poor as possible. And Donald Trump is fighting that. UKIP is fighting that. The Russians are fighting that. All we're bringing back is a prosperity-based system and a population growth system. Now, you can try to make population flat. You can argue there's some overpopulation in some areas. But all the numbers, all the actuaries, the science is in unequivocally. We are seeing massive implosions in population with an average of 1.3 birth rate replacement in the first world, which is the engine of all the other civilizations. While the globalists block development in the third world to collapse civilization, they should at least have 2.1 children to have replacement rate so things don't collapse. And the third world is already set to start planing off at about 9 billion around 2025. That's the UN's own numbers. Then it starts plunging rapidly after that. The globalists are adding, again, fire to that whole thing. They're adding fuel to the whole situation. I'm going to go back to David Knight here in a moment, but the reason I was thinking about that was we could put up on screen for TV viewers Business Insider article from a few years ago, but you can go out there and just for your own research and see thousands of studies how adding iodine to salt resulted in a decade's worth of IQ gains for the United States. 15-point increase the feds registered after a decade of them putting it in the water in 1930s. Then they pulled the mandate in the 1970s. And that's even cruddy iodine. Now, this isn't a pitch for InfoWars X2 that is the purest, cleanest, best iodine out there, period. The stuff they sell in stores, I wouldn't take it. It'd leave a hole in your stomach. And I'm not going to even get into this because it's not hurting us, but you know when there's a talking point, when you see 20 articles in a week saying Jones is insane, iodine's kooky, no one uses it, there's no proof it does anything for your body. What? You die without it. But I'm not even going to give attention to these articles because I went and read. They have no comments on big public. I mean, people just, what? It's like saying you don't need any vitamin C. You die without it in a couple months. I mean, this is the mainstream media now that won't say Ali or Muhammad when the bombers attack. That's coming up after your calls. This is so comical if it wasn't so serious. Ladies and gentlemen, the governments of the world under Codex Alimentarius, the UN, every year are lowering the standard of what they claim you need of iodine, what you need of the good halogen, what you need of vitamin C, what you need of vitamin A, D12. And they got articles out saying, I'm crazy. There's no proof vitamin B12 is good for your brain. You die without it. Almost everyone above 75, look it up. It's even in the New York Times, for heaven's sakes. It's so schizophrenic out. Oh, this is horrible. Admit that you can't absorb it in your gut. And then old people's brains disintegrate. It's crazy, folks. You've got to inject it or take it under the tongue. That's what doctors tell you. I decided to come out with this a few years ago because I went to a medical doctor when I was 40 and they were selling it, but by prescription. And I found out we could go make the same stuff under the tongue. I still inject vitamin B12. I hate needles. I don't stick it in my belly fat because I like sticking a needle in me every few days. And I take Secret 12. And I'll tell you, it doesn't absorb as much as an injection. But light years better than the pill. But it's the exact same stuff. I mean, you look at this wall of ignorance, folks. I have articles here. I'm going to go to David Novick. I want his take on separate issues than your calls. Where they are in the news. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. And they are saying that they're not going to say the word terrorism anymore. Now the BBC's not doing it. And they changed the guy's name in the latest attack. They have them every day. Machete attacks, action attacks, shooting attacks. A guy blew himself up and his name was Ali. First name. So they changed it to David. BBC scrubs Ali from Munich Killer's name on TV and articles and on social media. And then in a new one where the guy, that's the shooter, blew themselves up. They said an Afghan refugee was blown up by a bomb planted by Germans. And then when it turns out it's a Muslim foreigner, they always say they're a German or a Frenchman. They're changing nationalities. They're changing religions. They're changing names. And then there's this latest one. Look at this. BBC reports German suicide bombing as if suicide bomber was the victim. Leftist media outlet continues to make apologies for Islamicists. That's like saying Jeffrey Dahmer was the victim of someone making him eat human meat. Or that's like saying Ted Bundy was the victim of being tortured to death in a basement. I mean, it's just, I've got to tell you something. I know Orwell was writing about Stalinistic systems that were already in place in Russia, but I would still read that book and think this would never happen. Now, they're beyond this in many cases, David. What do you make of them saying you do not need vitamin C, you do not need vitamin B12, you do not need iodine? I mean, that's like saying you do, Alex, I can sell cans of air. They'd come out and say you don't need oxygen. I could have a deal, say, in Cancun, where I ran a little place with a couple boats, dive teams, and I would sell oxygen tanks, you know, filling them. And I would imagine they'd put out a call to the FDA to shut me down, claiming divers need oxygen. I mean, that is the equivalent of this insane. How far will they go? Do they think they control reality, or is it really effective, David Knight?
Well, Alex, you've talked a long time as to the elite saying they don't need us in the future. They're going to have robots. This is a transitional phase. They're already concerned about how they're going to try to control the masses. They call us the precariat. It's one of the key talking points of the latest elite confab at Bilderberg. So the question for them is, are they going to try to foment a divide and conquer civil war revolution that's going to be massively kill people? Or will they do a soft kill? What you're just talking about is part of the soft kill. Of course, they're proceeding with both aspects of that, the soft kill aspect, as well as creating the divide and conquer civil war, World War III, as they're trying to pick a fight again with the Russians, start up the Cold War. So they keep all of these options going at the same time.
That's right. And then they go, we've caught Alex Jones. He says the government's trying to kill you and then sells water filters. Exactly. We're funding ourselves, blocking enemy attacks and defensively, and then offensively taking the money and waging absolute information warfare and having devastating success. Absolutely. Everything I tell listeners to do, David, everything I tell them to do, I do myself. Don't these idiots understand integrity? Go ahead. Sorry.
Oh, that's right. You know, and, you know, I've used it myself. My friends have used it. We know if people try it, they know how it makes a difference in the way they feel.
Oh, yeah. They also say in these articles, notice Jones never makes claims. Why doesn't he show studies? Because the FDA says don't do that. So I'm going to say this.
Yeah.
You don't need iodine. You don't need DNA force. Even though that's patented, we can make claims. You don't need oxygen. You don't need anything. Okay. Just buy the products to help fund the operation. Okay. They're totally worthless. But if you want to fight tyranny, buy the products. There you go. You don't need vitamin C. You don't need vitamin A. You don't need vitamin B12. You don't need iodine. Okay. But buy the products if you want to fund us. Of course, that's satire. But I mean, fine. And they're so mad we won't make claims because they can't come after us. Because our listeners aren't idiots, scum. I guarantee the filth gives stuff to their kids, but they don't want our kids to have it. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Well, you know, Alex, on another note, you know, you're talking about supplements, but, you know, think about when you go to the restaurant, you get a Chinese fortune cookie. I'm looking at these balloons up here in the ceiling as we're waiting on break, and I was thinking, I wonder if there's 20,000 balloons up there. You know, we all remember the end of these conventions, as we just saw with the Republican convention, where they release all the balloons. Think about it. Each of those balloons having an incriminating email from the DNC inside of it, like a fortune cookie. Okay, that's really the release that's already happened at just prior to this convention. And we're going to see more of these things coming out, I believe, in the next few weeks. Or next few days, I should say.
I feel the spirit of liberty rising. Do you feel like momentum is totally turned against the globalist?
Yeah, but, you know, I really don't know if there's going to be a pushback amongst the people here in the convention, because one of the canaries in the coal mine, I would say, is the fact that when they were meeting in the rules committees, they decided, they tried to get rid of this whole idea of giving them so many superdelegates and trying to push back against that. They're leaving the entire system of superdelegates in place. So that tells you that the DNC, the Clinton people, are thoroughly in charge here. And I don't really know how many people that are going to be coming here as delegates are really going to do anything about it. I think inside the convention, I don't know that you're going to have a walkout. Certainly outside, we're seeing protests like we did not see at the GOP convention. It's a lot of anger out there, a lot of betrayal of the grassroots out there, and that's the key. It's the grassroots. The people in here, I think they're already part of this system. It'll be interesting to see what happens tonight when Bernie speaks. If there will be some kind of, you know,
exactly. Well, David, I know this. You're doing a fabulous job. So is the rest of the crew. Stuff happening every few minutes. Folks have to watch Infowars.com for the latest developments. TrojanReport.com is also on top of it, doing an amazing job. But regardless of what happens here, the Democratic Party is destroying itself. The establishment showing its butt to everybody. It's showing its skirt. This is irrevocable damage to the globalist. And they're going to have so much trouble ever putting this back together again. And we know the people that are going with the Hillary steal, they are the enemy. These are the folks that need to be held accountable.
Yeah, absolutely. And they need to understand, too, and they've seen this as it's gone along. Even before they started, you know, you talk about her being the Lance Armstrong of politics. You know, that's like giving him 15% into the race before they even started. That's where she was with the superdelegates. Sherry had 15% of the delegates.
Yeah, because a lot of the other folks were on drugs and stuff. He was just winning so well that he was kind of the scapegoat. And by the way, I don't like the guy. But this is like just giving her the race and she never gets on a bike and she weighs 800 pounds. This is like giving a hippopotamus from Mars the you know, the award, even though we've never seen it. David Knight, we'll keep following your stories. Thank you so much. Phone calls straight ahead. Get ready. Michelle, Liz, Sam, Mark, Chad, and others. Your phone calls are only about 1 minute away. But first, I mentioned it, but you shouldn't just mention something like this. You should show it. Hillary, during a press conference announcing Kane as her running mate, they were asking people in the press conference, how many of you are naturalized citizens? Just simply playing to that, opening up the gates, bringing in a big enough voting force to do whatever the globalists want. And she said that she's naturalized. And one of our crew members had a good point to make before we play the clip. CJ, where do you think she naturalized from?
I think she immigrated from hell. Burning fire of Hades.
I'm telling you, she immigrated from somewhere, I guess. And people think she doesn't know what that means. She does. She thinks her constituents are so dumb, she just wants to show solidarity. See, this is upside down world. So let's go ahead and play the clip.
If you haven't done this, go to a naturalization service where people become U.S. citizens. It is... How many of you, raise your hand if you have been a naturalized citizen. If you, yeah, wow, thanks for choosing us. Thanks.
Wow. Okay, let's go ahead now and let's take a phone call from Michael in Texas. Thanks for holding her on the air.
Alex, it's an honor to speak with you. I saw Hillary's America yesterday. I knew most of it because I consider myself very awake and very informative. The prime directive here is to stop the Clinton crime family. And after yesterday's film, it even makes that even more important. And on your show, sir, I challenge every Never Trump, every black American, and every left-wing sycophant, spend the $10, see the movie, and then I dare you to ever vote Democrat or stay home again.
Well, listen, the Never Trump people, most of them are moles. They've always been operatives. They're handlers. They're Democratic Party people forever. That's how they took over the Republican Party with George Herbert Walker Bush. They know what they're doing. But yes, especially the Bernie people, they should all vote for Trump. It's key to reach out to them. It's key to get them in swing states and other areas. But here's the problem. They stole it in California already from Bernie. They're going to steal it from Trump. So Trump has to start beating the drum. Hey, crooked Hillary, You stole it from Sanders. He really won. Here's the numbers. Don't think you're doing it to me, witch. And believe me, Trump was meeting last night. I'm authorized to say that. It's one of the big news. People don't care. I break all this big news. Preparing to try to defeat the steal. I mean, it is on, Michael.
Yes, it is, Alex. But we cannot be deterred for 1 minute. And you talked about spreading the word. You have said for months now that you want people to do their own podcast, do their own YouTube channel. I've been doing mine for 6 years.
Good job.
I want to drive down to Austin. I want to meet you and your InfoWars team. And I know.
Well, sure. Well, here's the problem. If I ever met one person, there'd be 50,000 people down the street. I'm meeting with no one unless I go out in public at events and it's a public event. Hell will freeze over, unfortunately, as a rule, before I talk to anyone. So I can't do it. I'm fighting. I'm working all the time. I just can't do it. But I do encourage people to have their own media outlet, and people can call in and plug their shows. What's the name of your show?
May I?
Yeah, I just said so.
May I promote my own stuff?
As you said, go ahead. Quick? Yeah.
Okay. I'm on 10 a.m. Central Time. That's my podcast, Monday through Friday. It's called Mike's Hot Seat, Left is Never Right. And my Facebook page is called Seeking Higher Truth.
Like all right, I got to jump. But listen, brother, I think you're a regular listener, but I don't screen your calls. You can call in. I love people plug their stuff, but you don't have to sit there and like, wow, I can really talk about it. People call me and say, can I paint InfoWars on the side of my building? Absolutely. It's free speech. You don't need my permission. So we want everybody to be out there and ferreting out news and picking up on things, and it's so important. I'm going to go to break and make more calls, a long segment. But listen, so many times it's a smaller YouTube channel or a blog or a website or a radio show that's local that sees the big event or sees the lie that puts it out, points it out, that then gets picked up nationally, globally. And then that ends up making your podcast big. And the goal should be have your own local radio show that's also on the internet, your own access show, whatever. Start wherever you can, and then have a newsletter, coffee cups, T-shirts to fund yourself. You deserve to be able to pay for your cameras and equipment and maybe make enough money to go on a trip and cover things. And these preachers say, just pray to God, he's going to give you money. Well, that's not true. That prosperity message is voodoo. You have to go out for the right reason to want to fight tyranny, take action, do it, have passion. It might take a month, might take 5 years. You will end up having a huge effect. And then you should be able to fund yourself. What the Clintons and the Clinton Foundation and the Clinton Library were so scared of in those thousands of pages that the media got when they sued and got them, WorldNet Daily, was we can't let a new media start in the early 90s and fund itself. We have to demonize anybody that has a media outlet outside of mainstream news that's making any money. And so that's all a talking point. Look at Alex Jones. He funds himself. How dirty. They don't ever want you to go out and do that. We have to build our own economy. Coming up on Wednesday, 28-hour marathon broadcast in the middle of Hitler's coronation. When I say she's being coronated, Bernie Sanders, hands down, and this has been in the news. We need to get all the demographics and numbers and show folks. He was the huge winner of California, at least 10 other states, like New Hampshire. He was way ahead of her. All the real polls showed that. And we can't find real Hillary supporters, hardly. I mean, it's incredible. And now they're just going to hand it all to her. This is unprecedented. So that broadcast is coming up. Right now, let's go ahead and go to Liz in Minnesota. Liz, you're on the air. Thanks for calling.
Hi, Alex. I'm a big fan.
Thank you.
Excuse me. I was just wondering, I've been paying attention to the DNC, and my boyfriend and I have been watching your show and CNN, and we just saw Bernie Sanders endorse Clinton and trying to get all of his supporters to back her. And we thought this was a little odd because he has yet to drop out or concede. And so, and like you said, it's hard to find a Hillary supporter. So, in fact, I believe he got booed on stage. So I'm just wondering what you think this is indicating. What are they doing here? It's a very strange move politically.
Well, they're trying to act like they didn't steal it and try to confuse people and hope they forget California, where it was in the New York Daily News and other papers, that we should pull those articles back up, that they chose Hillary as the winner at a rich guy's house with the Associated Press and the superdelegates. They got together and all convinced themselves, hey, we're not even elected. We're governors and people, but we're just going to say we're going for Hillary. So here's who's going to win tomorrow. And then they announced on the news, though, here's the numbers of Hillary and him on air. That's all a fraud. It's crazy town. It's like a horse, you know, beating another horse by a mile in a 2 mile race. And there's video of the horse winning. It's standing over on the side of the grass, you know, eating grass or peeing or whatever they do after they race. That's what they tend to do. That's why I said that. And there's other horses still running around. It's Hillary. And they're just telling us she's the winner. So it's so over the top, people have trouble even computing it. But Sanders is halfway said, we're going to fight for our values into the convention. But Hillary is, you know, he's kind of halfway done it. And so I think he's going to say, we must be unified. We must work to reform this system of the Democratic Party and problems there. But I will continue to work for you. But Donald Trump and his fascism and racism and white people do not know what it's like to be poor. And so I hate that. So I think you're still going to see some of that.
Oh no! Damn it! Oh no!
Did you know that the principal from Beavis and Butthead actually is Bernie Sanders? He was the voice.
Watch your mouth, you little sons of bitches! What?
No. He didn't wear a wig on the show, though. I'm glad you found that one, but there's the one they did where, I'm going to go back to you in a minute, ma'am, where they cut 9/11 Truth, like Beavis and Butthead 9/11 Truth. It's by a guy called Pirate 4900 or something, I'm going from memory. And then, you kids are suspended for the rest of the year. I mean, that is Bernie Sanders, and he speaks about it as well. Excuse me. Liz, I mean, what do you think is really going on? I mean, we know they've stolen it. I've never seen numbers where 80% of the people all over the country, whether it's Michigan or California or Texas, I mean, no one but rich people. When I drive sometimes through the really rich areas, I see Hillary signs in Austin, Tarrytown. When I'm going over there to visit people I know, it is unbelievable. Sometimes I cut through to there, too, to come downtown from West Austin, and I see some Hillary signs. I see some Hillary stickers. That's it. I mean, it's all Bernie Sanders. It's got to be bumper sticker and sign-wise, 15-1. The best is 8-2. What do you think?
Well, I think she might get the DNC vote, but I think it's going to come down to the election in November, and I think Trump's going to win.
I'm sorry, ma'am. My audio cut out for just a minute. What did you say?
She might get the DNC backing, but I think when it comes down to the vote in November, that Trump's going to win.
I hear you, but and I get it. They, quote, have rules they changed with the superdelegates where they can disregard the delegates in 1972, but never had the huevos to actually try to do it. They tried it with Trump. That failed. So maybe you're right. Maybe stealing the big super enchilada, or to use a Ghostbusters analogy, the 8,000-pound Twinkie, maybe that is too much, especially if they know that Mr. Trump is already shifted into, quite frankly, focusing on stopping her steal. What do you think?
Oh, I'm just amazed by all of this and kind of appalled by the whole political sphere. So I'm just going to vote Trump in November and see what happens.
Exactly, ma'am. And listen, don't let it get you down that it looks like it's so corrupted out in the open. That's good. Forcing this thing out in the open is key. And so, again, they don't put the genie back in the bottle. Pandora's box is wide open. I want to go back to calls here. We're going to talk to, thank you, Liz. We're going to talk to Chad in Kentucky, Marco, Mark, Sam, George, and others. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. But let's play some more of these clips because the crew gets a lot of these, you know, the ladies and others get a lot of these clips together. And I tend to not go to a lot of them, but these are important, including clips I've asked for. Which one of these should I go to next? I think I'm going to play some of these clips. Hillary on DNC email leak. Don't know anything about these emails. And, of course, she said 2 years ago, 3 years ago, she knew nothing about the other emails, didn't have a private email server, lied to everybody, then lied about cutting off the classified part. We all know that. But now she has turned into a Sergeant Schultz yet again. I know nothing, nothing, sir. Oh, no, I know nothing. So let's go ahead and play that clip from 60 Minutes.
The point, Madam Secretary, is you have people in the Democratic National Committee who are supposed to be, if you will, agnostic about who the nominee is going to be. And they seem to have their thumb on the scale for you. They seem to be working against Bernie Sanders, their fellow Democrat.
Again, I don't know anything. I don't know anything about these emails.
I
haven't followed it. But I'm very proud of the campaign that I ran. And I'm very proud of the campaign right. that Senator Sanders yeah. ran.
In your view, any effort in the DNC to favor one candidate or another would have been improper?
Again, I don't have any information about this, and so I can't answer specifically.
Oh.
We ran our campaign. We ran hard. We worked to have as many successes as possible. I'm very proud that we got more votes than anybody else running, including Donald Trump. And I am very grateful for the campaign that Senator Sanders ran, because we ran a campaign based on issues, not insults. So I can't speak to what people who were not working for me, who were saying whatever they were saying. I can't speak to that. I can only speak to my campaign.
Okay. I am flabbergasted. I've seen the numbers a bunch of times. I need the latest. As of, look it up, guys. As of the last primary, I think Trump got like 3.8 million votes. I'm going from memory, more than any other Republican in history. And then I remember seeing, even like in like New York Times, LA Times breakdowns, that Hillary got less Democratic votes than the last election. She just said she had more general population votes than I'm just flabbergasted by these lies. I mean, flabbergasted at how, because the media won't challenge her. And now she knows nothing about the superdelegates that they've spent decades putting into place in the DNC party elections that she honchos, commands, runs. And that her minion, Debbie Wasserman Schultz, has worked for decades, now leaving the DNC to go back to work for her again. What a joke. She knows nothing about it. She knows nothing about stealing all the states or being at the meeting in California to decide they wouldn't give it to Bernie. I mean, wow, wow. What another galactic-sized super whopper. How Hillary loses. Donald Trump can actually win if Clinton makes these four mistakes. Spoiler alert, she's already making all of them. That was from back in May. Yeah, we're going to look up the numbers. She got less votes than Trump. It doesn't matter. In her mind, she got more. And she was in major combat. You all know she's like Brian Williams. Brian Williams is actually flying a Star Destroyer in deep space, Battlestar Galactica fighting space aliens. He said so, and so it must be true. These people, it's just like a joke. They will destroy themselves if they're lying. Let's go to this other one. Let's go ahead and play the Hillary standard for corruption from 60 Minutes. Here it is.
I was speaking to a young African-American man just the other day in a Democratic state, and he said, and I'll quote, "You know, I guess I would vote for Hillary except for that corruption problem," end quote. As I talked to him further, he didn't quite know what he meant by that, but that was his impression and concern. Why do you think people say that about you?
Well, first, I will take responsibility for any impression or anything I've ever done that people have legitimate questions about. But I think that it's fair to say there's been a concerted effort to convince people like that young man of something. Nobody's quite sure what, but of something. I often feel like there's the Hillary standard, and then there's the standard for everybody else.
What's
and
the Hillary standard?
Well, it is, you know, a lot of, as you saw at the Republican convention, unfounded, inaccurate, mean-spirited attacks with no basis in truth, reality, which take on a life of their own. And for whatever reasons, and I don't want to try to analyze the reasons. I see it. I understand it. People are very willing to say things about me, to make accusations about me that are I don't get upset about them anymore, but they are very regrettable.
Why do you put
all lies? She gets totally upset about it and mentally throws fits. She said there's a Hillary standard and another standard. Total inverted reality. Yes, everybody else will go to jail. You're above the law. That's right. General Flynn said, yes, she should go to prison. If I did one-tenth of what she did, I would be in jail. She is a Bradley Manning. She's a girl. Put her in the same jail cell as Bradley Manning. But Bradley Manning was exposing criminal activity. Probably released too much stuff. A lot of the stuff was not criminal activity. Was not. That was the biggest problem. Was a bunch of it was didn't danger people. But people should. If you're going to put something out, you should go through it. The argument with WikiLeaks is just put everything out. I don't know if you want to put the names of informants and stuff in Iraq so they get killed and stuff like that. I mean, I get why they threw him in prison. The thing is, he still meant well. And Snowden was very careful about what he did. I think the guy's a hero because the program and all that's illegal. All right, let's just stop right there. I want to go back to your phone calls, but I know the crew was really upset about this clip. Any of you guys, I'm putting you on the spot here, from Matt to Allie to whoever. I mean, do you want to comment before I go to calls about this Hillary standard? Because she's, in a weird way, she's telling the truth. Yeah, there's a Hillary standard, but not that you get in trouble when nobody else does. Everybody else gets in trouble, but you don't.
Well, yeah, I thought it was just outrageous when he basically called her on the fact that she's being associated with corruption, and you could see just all the lies and criminal activities are going through her head, and she's trying to cover up for it and come up with another lie and how to cover it up. You could just see that in her head. So I thought it was a great clip.
Now, Dari, I don't know if I get into what you did before you worked here, but you've been at the Defense Language School. You were in at Fort Bragg, and I mean, you haven't told me the details, but obviously black ops and things. And I mean, if you ever did one-tenth of what Hillary did, is General Flynn accurate in saying you'd be in prison?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. For far less than that. Far less.
So where do you think this is going?
It's hard to tell. I mean, I don't know. She's just going to get away with the stuff that she's getting away with because they just have it controlled. So I don't know. I just hope Trump actually gets into the presidency and finally does something about it.
Well, there's got to be some limit to it. Thank you for making those points. It's simply amazing. Let's just play it one more time, then I'm going to your calls, because I want everybody each hour to be able to hear this or see this. But if you're not a TV viewer, go to Infowars.com/show. And you can actually see this. You got Schultz getting up trying to start organizing today. I guess this was today. Getting the delegates to go, okay, I know you're all here for Sanders, but get ready. We're going to steal it. And they start booing her. So they want to have this rubber stamp claiming we met with everybody and they said I. Well, guess what? They didn't say I. They said boo. And then they bring up, they're mad at me. Bring up another woman. I'm the woman. Be quiet. All of you stand down. Well, most of those Democrats are women, something like 59%. They didn't go along with you either. They're all mad. Oh, the gimmick of it being a woman's wearing off, isn't it? So let's go ahead and play Debbie Wasserman Schultz booed and heckled at Florida delegation breakfast at DNC. Here it is.
Good morning, Florida.
Good morning, Florida.
Everybody settle down, please. Okay. All right, we have a big program. We have a big program today. Let's hear. Let's be respectful. Please be quiet so Debbie can speak. It's okay. Everybody, let's hear from our speakers. We have other speakers as well.
it goes on and on, on and on and on. How long can they push this? We're going to go to break and come back with Chad in Kentucky. And we're going to talk to other folks like Mark in Oregon, Terry in Georgia, George and others. And then, of course, Leanne McAdoo with a whole fresh new hour, tons of news, breaking analysis. It's all coming up. Please mark your calendars. It's only 2 days away. In fact, what's the countdown time-wise at Infowars.com/giant? It's only 2 days. Less than 2 days till Wednesday, 11 a.m. We kick off a 28-hour live transmission with reporters all over the world. We're 1 day, 5 hours, 9 minutes, 14 seconds from Operation Sleeping Giant. The American people stand up. Think of what we do each year, how we metrically are intensifying our operations. We're exponentially growing. You know, this is a pretty important headline, but I think we ought to change it. InfoWars dominates DNC coverage by illustrating Dem divide. Report shows party more split than Republican. How about InfoWars finds 80% of people on the ground don't support, or 80% of Democrats don't support Hillary in ground poll. Party completely split, imploding. Something like that. I mean, they're in trouble. Briefly, I'm not going to belabor this. We sell amazing products at some of the lowest prices out there, whether it's an indoor air purifier or water purifying system you need, or non-GMO heirloom seeds, or nutraceuticals. It's all available at InfoWarsStore.com. And we have 10% off this week on the nutraceuticals, part of the operation we've launched, Operation Sleeping Giant, to help raise capital. Please take action, take advantage of 10% off on all the nutraceuticals at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsStore.com has a lot of other great sales as well. Whether it's the best ultrasound toothbrush you can find out there with ultraviolet light to kill germs, that is literally less than a third of the cost of many of the models out there that aren't even as good, or whether it is a book on the dangers of GMO, thousands and thousands of items at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com to find the nutraceuticals. InfoWarsHealth.com is the full longevity line, discounted. When you purchase it there at InfoWarsHealth.com, part of the proceeds go to fund this operation as well. So also check out the great products at InfoWarsHealth.com or InfoWarsTeam.com. All right, let's go to Chad in the great state of Kentucky. Chad, you're on the air. Thanks for holding.
Thank you, Alex. Just got two quick questions, three if you got time. But what do you think of Russia banning evangelicalism? And two, with Hillary going down in the polls and everyone catching on to this Hillary for prison, I don't think the puppet masters can really ram her down our throat like they want to. I think we need to start worrying about an Obama third term here.
All right. I know Russia's banned hundreds of groups that are basically George Soros-backed. I know there are some evangelical groups who have been caught. I mean, that's, governments always use Christian groups or religious groups, you know, missionaries as covers, journalists as covers. So some journalists have been barred from Russia who they believe are actually globalist spies. I'm not defending some of the stuff going on in Russia, but when you're being attacked, that's the type of things governments do. But can you cite for me specifically where evangelical group is banned from Russia?
No, not specifically, just a lot of Christian posts and stuff like that. I've seen,
there's a lot of rumors. Russia is becoming more Christian and defending Christians. It's only banning known CIA groups like Pussy Riot, that's the name of it, and others that are admittedly going into churches and crapping all over the Virgin Mary and things like that.
Okay.
I mean, you understand these women are going to do this to be arrested and to cause a riot. You understand that, right? They send women in to urinate and defecate on things at churches. Our CIA on record funds them to do that. And then the Russians arrest them and they say, oh, and throw them out of the country. And they say, oh, look, we're censored. And then they put out lies that Russia is arresting Christians and stuff. It is horse manure.
Yeah, I just wanted to clarify that up. But I do think we got to worry about an Obama third term, you know, having a false flag and keeping him in office. I think you even had someone on the show prior to the elections kicking off that said that this was all going to be a big circus to be a distraction, and then Obama's going to remain in office.
Absolutely. I mean, I think anything goes now. Stuff's gotten so crazy where they just steal elections openly and tried to with Trump and get on Fox News and go, your vote doesn't count. They've just coup d'etat Roger Ailes. They've told drugs they're coming after him. Get ready. All hell's breaking loose. But here's the deal. We're having major gains in the fight. It's not like we're in a fight and we're just laying here. But I hear you. I think there's a good chance. Listen, I smell a false flag. And I'm telling you, I think anything's in the cards, from a federal building being blown up and, you know, it being, you know, Trump supporters that do it, they'll claim, to a nuke being shut off. I mean, I think they could do anything. These criminals think they're invincible. They think they're going to get arrested if they don't stay in power. And so they're like a bank robber when the cops come that takes a woman with her kid hostage. Back off or I'll shoot the kid. Well, you can't give in to terrorism. So Hillary wants to shut off nukes or come after me or whatever she's got to do. Just, you know, this is the way it is. It's like True Grit. We're riding in against them. And fill your hand because it's on. We'll be back in 70 seconds with more phone calls. Mark in Oregon. Terry, stay with us. I know this is real. I know the world government's real. Not just from their documents or actions. I've had them try to buy me off. I've had them attack me. I've had them do terrible things to my family. But you know what? I have good cheer because God always took me through it. Wounded and scarred, but it only made me stronger. But I know now I'm just going to do the best I can, give it all to God, and God will take us the rest of the way. And that's all you can do is just commit, and that's the end of it. Doesn't mean we don't fall down. Doesn't mean we don't make mistakes. I'm going to hold over a little bit with Leanne in this next segment to finish some of these calls, but she'll be joining us here in about 5 minutes. In fact, you can see her right there on the screen. Hello, Leanne. Okay, the crew's not in there yet, but we're going to go to her in a minute. I want to go to Jeremy, and then I'm going to go to Marco and George and Terry and Michael, but then that'll be it for calls. At least Leanne may take some. But Jeremy in California, we put callers that disagree to the head of the line. And he says he disagrees with a Young Turk scuffle. Now this became a big diversion. Again, I could be on 500 shows if I wanted to. Everywhere I went, I had like 15 cameras around me. I was in thousands of newspapers. We have more views than the Young Turks with all of our YouTube channels combined. They have a huge YouTube channel as well. But when it goes to metrics, Google Analytics, our website's more than 10,000 times bigger than them. But it isn't about who's bigger. They just kept saying, you're small, you're pathetic, afterwards, and lying. Now, I don't know if Chink or Sink, however you say his name, I always get it wrong. I don't know. In fact, I didn't mean to do this, but anyways, we're talking about now. We've got footage in the thing we can show for TV viewers. It's like, what really happened with the Young Turks and Alex Jones? And you can really see what happened. We're walking by. Everybody's waving like fishmongers over to their area. It's just stages everywhere, crammed into this parking garage that has a tent over it, big air conditioners blasting in. It was awesome. It was like 65 degrees in there. I loved it. I guess the opposite of the Democrats' deal. And which they say is like 90 degrees. And so I was like, hey, Young Turks. And I saw some guy in a suit. They all kind of look the same, like all the white guys on the show kind of have little trendy beards and hair, curly hair. So I just remember, okay, yeah. Then Leanne's like, yeah, you ought to go on there. It'd be fun. So we do like a bunch of other interviews. We're coming back later, and I'm walking along, and I go, I guess I'll do it. So I did kind of jump up on the stage, and at first he's real nice because I guess he'd heard I was in there and wanted me there. Then the guy, I think he's the guy that invited me up, because again, the four or five co-hosts kind of look the same. Shink looks different, but other than the girl, these trendies all kind of look the same, because it's all a blur in there. But he runs up and starts screaming, it's Alex Jones, yeah, he's taking over Alex Jones, as the trigger for Shink to blow up and say, get out of here and get out of here, Roger Stone. Roger Stone's like 15, 20 feet away, and had done nothing. So regardless of what you say, Roger Stone did not want to be on it, did not try to get on it, and Shink went out and the media said Roger Stone crashed his deal. Now, you could say I halfway crashed it, but I didn't threaten to attack people. I didn't spit in people's faces, and I didn't file a police report, even though the police were there and wanted to arrest him when they saw the video. And I said, no, I don't want to do it. The state police actually got mad. So in turn, I leave, and an hour later, our videos are being taken down. They were on the YouTube stage. And clearly, I said, okay, we know you're behind it, YouTube. We're going after you. And they put them back up. Now, Jeremy, you say you disagree with what happened. Go ahead and just real quick, give me your point. Jeremy, can you talk? Are you able to speak? These people are just, go ahead. It's a Hillary voter. He can't talk. Go ahead, Hillary voter. These people are so weird, man. Is this a joke? They just wanted me to talk about it. I mean, you know. CJ, and I'm going to come back and take a few calls, let him go, had the exact same thing that I did. I said, what do you think about it? And he said, I think it's a horrible diversion from how you dominated coverage, Hillary for president, all the newspapers saying at the coronation of King Trump, you know, or the coronation of Trump, Alex Jones was king. It's not about me. It's the message. I mean, everything admitted we dominated, we took over. Charlie Rose freaked out and said, I can't believe how you're taking over everything. You know, it just shows our success. Trump's amazed. I'll leave it at that. I had dinner with Nigel Farage. So much stuff I'm not going to talk about in Fight Club. But I love how the left is always trying to tell us how small we are and how we're pathetic. No, we're not. You're dying, we're exploding, and we don't need you. Media's always been war. They just don't want you to know there's a war on. We want you to know there's a war. Truth is our ultimate weapon. And you notice our war is having big, big dividends. Big payoffs for liberty. But it takes fuel to fund this engine. This is a shirt I designed. It's a shirt made in America. We made a really special deal to be able to keep the price down on this. It's top quality fabric. Super soft, super durable. Made in America, cotton from America, printed in America, $22. We have a camo one, and then we have two gray versions. And it's my favorite shirt I wear when I'm exercising, when I'm out and about. We got thousands of these printed, 2,000, and then I never even plugged it. I've been so busy for 2 months, they've just sat there on the shopping cart. This is the ultimate shirt, in my view. It's a Texas flag, Spirit of Texas Worldwide. It says, come and take it. And then it's got a classic cannon. Then there's also an M4 or AR-15 version in all three variants. I personally like the AR-15 or M4 style one, but the classic cannon is nice as well. Everybody needs to get this shirt. On the back it says, don't tread on me, with the Gadsden flag symbol and a snake. So it's available right now. And we don't make a lot of money on these shirts because when they're made in America and they're this good of fabric and all the rest of it, even though I printed a whole bunch of them, I mean, it's like, what is it, $9 a shirt? So, you know, I can buy them for like $3, $4 a shirt if they're not made in America. And then we still print them here. And we got the choices for you. But this is a made in 1776 product. Made in 1776.com takes you right to the subsection of all our made in America products. We've got the Moan Labe caps, other common tickets, Make America Free Again, and so much more. I want to take a few final calls and hand the baton to our own Leanne McAdoo. But Leanne, finishing up with the Young Turks thing, because you were there, I thought you might want to respond to it. I don't want to spend too long. This really is a sickening diversion. But the way the fake left are such totalitarians, the way they're hypocrites, the way she said, I was a fat bitch. So both attacking women and attacking, when she says never fat shame, that's her specialty, we should ban it.
I think she actually called me the B word.
And then spitting on people, and then saying Stone, who was 20 feet away, get out of here, Stone, stop taking over. Elliot Spitzer never did anything with hookers.
Yeah, telling Roger Stone that he was yucky and gross. Meanwhile, he's apologizing for a rapist. So it's just, it's
we're not
so
even sure he's a rapist yet, but the point is we know he's had hooker problems and this woman ran off claiming she was
attacked. I was talking about Bill Clinton.
Oh, yeah, Bill Clinton.
He was
triggered. Bill Clinton has settled rapes. You're right.
Right. Well, you know, the only thing I have to say about that is you can see the video for yourself, and they showed their true colors. Like I've said, I don't really appreciate them. I think they're super huge bullies, and that was evident in the videos that you've seen.
Why did we have any problems on the dozens of other shows we did before and after?
Before and after. That was the only time. So
I mean, it's not like we snuck on Universal Studios set, you know, and just we were like, you know, oh, they're big set. No, it was the YouTube set. But what do you make of them pulling our YouTube videos?
Well, obviously, you know, they're on the YouTube stage. And so that what they did, if they had it down for just even that hour, that gave it the opportunity for the Young Turks videos to get all of the viral hits, because everyone, as soon as that happened, because it was live, was trying to search, trying to go find it. And so they took ours down. So that immediately gave the Young Turks the jump on the views for the video. So
and it just shows how their establishment, though.
Exactly.
It just shows how every time everything's rigged with these people.
They're part of the machine, and people got to wake up to this. Everyone thinks that they're so cool just because they cuss, and young people go, oh, wow, these people are talking about politics.
By the way, Al Jazeera owned their show that's funded by Qatar and a couple other Gulf states and the Saudi Arabian royal family. And when I brought that up, and then, hey, she's a Muslim or whatever, why aren't she wearing a hijab, you know, and all this stuff? I mean, you know, this guy's an Islamic apologist.
Yeah, and apologies for cop killers and things like that. I just, you know, it's all part of the movement to foment this civil unrest in this country, and people just really need to understand what's happening. And, you know, we have a lot of people coming out saying, oh, well, you just want the views and the hits. No. I mean, Alex, let's just look at reality here. You only started putting the auto subscribe on your YouTube channel, getting people to say, hey, be sure you click subscribe. We did that about 7-8 months ago, and you got a million. You've already gotten a million more YouTube subscribers just in the last 7 months. Imagine if you had that auto subscribe on the whole time.
Well, let's be clear. I mean, I haven't known what I'm doing on many fronts for years. We have more than 20 YouTube channels. Just ours alone are 2.5 billion. Now, let me expand. One channel with 900 million. Now, let me expand. We then have more than 18 Facebook channels that we just started uploading to. Those are already up to over 150 million. Now, let me explain. We have affiliated channels that aren't ours because the Turks hit you with copyright. They have their site, which is pushed by Google, which is partnered with Google. Without being pushed by Google and having all the stuff happen over the years, I mean, let's talk facts. We are on tens of thousands of channels, and I even, with Google and YouTube, came to me a few years ago, a vice president, and they said, listen, sir, we'd like you to not let everybody have your videos because it's so big. You've got something like 10 billion views. You are the biggest thing on YouTube. The biggest. I mean, I'm not supposed to talk about this, so I'm just leave it there. I'm going to stop. And they said, because I have kind of partnered with them behind the scenes, so they won't censor me. Some of the censorship ended when I did this. I didn't even take ads before because I don't like Google. I said, okay, I'll take ads, but be legitimate and don't block my stuff anymore and take Obama deception down and stuff. Okay, and they said, fine. By the way, a lot of us like you. There's some good folks at Google that owns YouTube. So I'm now giving inside baseball out. We had 10 billion whoppers 2.5 years ago. 10 billion turds. 10 billion. 10 billion. And you know what I told them? I said, no, you can make money off our 30-something channels or whatever. And if you want to reach out to other people that are running our stuff and say that you want to share with them, then we'll sign off. I'm not going to copyright people. So there you go, turds. I have 10 billion. And I'm on almost 200 stations. And InfoWars is rated over 10,000 times above you in Google Analytics. So you're a joke. Even though the Arabs fund you, and even though the White House funds you, we destroy you. You little punk bully.
Right.
That guy was, I'm going to tell when somebody's really tough. That guy is such a bully, man.
Right.
And I didn't want to hit him, but if he hit me, I was going to pop him so hard.
I know. You totally started to square up, and you do that thing with your jaw where you're like, okay, I'm probably going to have to square up get my jaw bigger because I might get hit. Like, I thought it was really funny, and I tried not to kind of be excited in the background, but man, did it go left really quick. But let's stop talking about them.
Well, I mean, what happens is I start clenching my teeth. I don't do that on purpose.
I know, but you're like, ooh, our video was their most viewed video of their whole entire coverage of the event.
I just hope that fat punk understands it. I mean, I'm not trying, I'm a tough guy, but I mean, people I've been in fights with don't get back up sometimes.
Right. Well,
I want to be, you know, I'm sorry. That's just true. Everybody knows it's true. The government knows it's true.
Just, well, I mean, you were up there putting bunny ears on them and just kind of being goofy about the whole thing, and they just completely got triggered. I thought it was hilarious, but let that be the end.
I'm sorry to go off on that whole rant. It's just, it was just them threatening me, going, you better get out of here. You can hear it on the video, or you're going to get hurt. And like, you know, like dance around like he was a belly dancer. He's like, you did me. We soon have your country. At home, he's wearing a big turban.
Bring
in the girls.
I don't know about all that. I just
his
know that
social worker.
To be there in the presence, you could definitely feel a really dark, dark
worker.
Energy.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
You could just feel a really dark energy, and which I can sense through the
America camera. Is ours. Everyone knows the left is allied with radical Islam.
Yeah.
And well, Sink saw his enemy. Look, Sink used to like me when I was against invading the Middle East and everything, thinking I was one of his, you know, demis. Now, I just didn't want to kill Muslims and have a giant war. The war's on now. That's why he blew up, okay?
Right.
He saw a crusader. He's like, we took Constantinople. It is now Istanbul. It's all battle for Islam.
Well, obviously.
Saudi Arabia empower me to defeat Jones. Oh, please. I mean, I'm telling you.
Well,
bring forth Sink the Toad to battle Jones, the Golden Goblin.
Well, obviously, they've joined the establishment because you could see how quick they were to start backing Hillary Clinton and not, you know, not going against. I mean, these are people that were super for Bernie Sanders. They were part of that whole movement. But don't you dare say anything bad about Hillary Clinton or her husband.
I want to know why Sink's allowing his co-host to run around in that red dress.
She seemed like such a nice girl.
She's not allowed in Turkey, buddy. Why are you coming over here trying to? I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Well, all I know is we've got a jam-packed fourth hour for you.
Let me talk to Sink in his own language. There you go. Go ahead.
Well, we have got a jam-packed fourth hour for you guys. We want to get to these DNC leaks and what they're not telling you. And they're trying to blame it on the Russians, blame it on anybody. They need a boogeyman. So let's not get distracted ourselves. We got to stay on these people because, Alex, like you said, we are really witnessing an uprising here, the fall of the globalists, and this, they are so afraid of what's happening.
Send the Turks to America. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Oh, hey, let's name our show after a government that committed genocide. Woo.
Which Turk even, he even denies that happened. It's on the even the UN admits they killed a million innocent people.
Right.
Because they weren't Islamic.
They were Christians. Armenian Christians.
That'd be like if I named my show the Nazis. And people went, well, why are you calling yourself the Nazis? The Nazis killed everybody. And went, I don't even know what the Nazis are. It's just, I put a big, like, Charlie Manson swastika between my eyes and just, like, run around going, ach, blech, 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 blech. And because I'm a Muslim, it's okay, though.
You sort of sound like that tribe from the Game of Thrones. I can't think of the guy's name right now, but.
Well, you know, in the Turkish prisons, they admittedly are, quote, hog-tying and raping for days, the men. So, you know, the thing about Turkish prisons.
No, I know. Well, and that's the thing. It's like Erdogan is the good guy, right? He's our ally in all of this. Putin is the one that we all need to be super afraid of because they need a boogeyman. So, of course, they're.
Well, it doesn't matter. Russia has kicked Turkey's ass like 10 times.
Right. Well, I'm just really afraid for what they've got up their sleeve, Alex, especially with the fall of Hillary Clinton.
Hey, I bet they wouldn't even let Sink into Russia because they're not letting, quote, enemy media in. I bet he's on their list.
That'd be really interesting to find out. We could ask Margaret Howell if she has any inside scoop on that.
Why don't we just deport Sink, you know? I mean, you know.
Start a petition.
I'm joking. All right, Leanne, I got a bunch of callers. I'm going to let you take over. I got to go get ready for this 28-hour broadcast. I apologize to some of the people. If you can get to the end and get to them, that'd be nice. But I got a lot on the leaks. There I went crazy on the Young Turks. I did it. And that'll give that little bully something to blow up about, which is fine. But the facts are, buddy, we're changing the world. You're sinking. Saudi Arabians pulled out of funding in the Qataris. You know, bye-bye.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. You have now entered the Overdrive Hour. I am your host, Leanne McAdoo, taking the reins. Now, one of the big surprising things that has happened today at the DNC, Bernie Sanders actually came out and urged people to back Hillary. Of course, the crowd was absolutely outraged after Sanders came out and said this. This is even after the DNC leaks show that the system was rigged against him and his supporters the entire time. So here he's got people who, you know, a lot of people aren't getting paid that much. He's taking your money, saying that he's going to fight the establishment. He's the candidate that's really going to turn this thing around and fight back against the machine. And then he goes and backs the biggest establishment candidate that there is, even after these DNC leaks. What a huge hypocrite. Let's go ahead and just play a little bit of that video with Bernie Sanders turning on his supporters.
We have got to defeat Donald Trump.
See, he had him there.
And we have got to elect Hillary Clinton and Tim Kaine.
Boo. And I've been in there in that room. I know how loud those boos are. Look at him. A little hot under the collar there, Bernie. Boo. Lock her up. Hillary for prison. So you can hear the people chanting there. Look, the crowd has totally turned on him. So come on back, guys. Now, these are people. There are a lot of the people in that room. You can just sort of tell from the way they look. They are Bernie Sanders supporters. And they were saying, you know, Bernie must disavow. Of course, that was one of the top trending hashtags on Twitter over the weekend. And of course, Bernie Sanders' camp did come out and say Debbie Wasserman Schultz needs to step down. This is outrageous. And of course, she did step down and then immediately announced that she's going to join Hillary Clinton's campaign. So what does that tell you about the Clinton campaign? We have Debbie Wasserman Schultz stepping down over an ethics violation. And then immediately getting hired by Hillary Clinton as if she wasn't, you know, now I guess she can just officially be on the payroll. But this is something that we've been pointing out for a long time. This was never going to be about Bernie Sanders. I don't even think that they were expecting such a huge amount of young people. They didn't probably think he was going to tap into the zeitgeist. All along, Bernie Sanders was about forcing the Democratic Party even further to the left. One of these articles out of The Guardian, I think this is an opinion piece. It says, the DNC email leak doesn't show wrongdoing. Bernie is barely a Democrat. So now they're saying, well, it's not bad that the DNC was working against Bernie Sanders the entire time. He wasn't even a Democrat. So that's kind of the new narrative there, so that they're going to placate Bernie Sanders supporters. But I did a report a while back on, you know, what's the difference between a Democrat and a Democratic Socialist. And one of the things that I reported on is if you look at the Democratic Socialists of America's website, one of the things that they answer there in their Q&A, it says, the question is, aren't you a party that's in competition with the Democratic Party for votes and support? And they go on to say, no, we're a separate party, but they work together with the people who they think are going to support progressives and who have a real chance at winning elections, which usually means left-wing Democrats. And they go on kind of more in detail, just showing you that they're a separate party, but they're going to support the really progressive people in the Democratic Party, the left-wing people there, like Hillary Clinton, who they know can get elected. And what Bernie Sanders was put in to do was force the Democrats even further to the left, even into more of these progressive socialist policies. And as we've seen from many people that they say, many young people, you press them, and they admit their ultimate goal is communism. And then they'll tell you how great communism is, and even though it's killed hundreds of millions of people, we should try that here in America because it is so wonderful and so great. It's just the whole thing is rigged, and you guys need to admit it now. You've been totally duped, and Bernie Sanders, what a disappointment for him to come out and say that at the DNC. And I'm really glad that the crowd is now getting to see what's really going on, and that this whole system was rigged, not against him, but against the American people. Now, one of the things that I thought was really exciting when we were at the RNC was seeing Alex Jones on the ground with his microphone in hand. It was like vintage Alex Jones actually going out and interviewing people. He got to talk to Don King. I think he met his favorite globalist, who was that Charlie Rose. And one of the people that we had the chance to interview was Ann Coulter. And she was just there, and she was really kind of excited to see Alex Jones and Roger Stone. She had an interview right after they did. So we went ahead and grabbed her while we had the chance. And here is what Ann Coulter wanted to say to American voters.
Well, here she is, the firebrand of hardcore conservatism. That's right, Ann Coulter here at the RNC on the final day, 2016. Is this history happening? I've never felt so much energy.
Yeah, because there are no Bushes, no Kasich, no McCain. But I do think tonight's the big night. I've been in Cleveland, but really just eating and drinking to celebrate the fruits of my victory, Trump.
All right, guys, sorry, I didn't know we didn't have enough time. We'll go ahead and show the rest of that interview on the InfoWars YouTube channel, Alex Jones YouTube. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I am your host, Leanne McAdoo, here in the Overdrive Hour. Joining me now in this segment is Margaret Howell, our new and wonderfully lovely reporter. We're going to be getting to some of the what they're not telling you about the DNC leaks. And before we get into that, I just want to remind everyone that we are going to be launching our 28-hour broadcast, the Operation Sleeping Giant, starting this Wednesday. And I have a very special product that I am going to be, everyone's going to be signing it. This is the shirt, the Clinton rape shirt that triggered Cenk on the set. And you're also going to get the badge from the radio TV there on Thursday. We're all going to sign it, but this is the triggering shirt right here. And that is going to be up for auction during our 28-hour broadcast. That's coming up this week, Operation Sleeping Giant. I am so excited about that. We always have so much fun. It seems sort of like, oh my gosh, 28 hours of broadcasting, but it's always a blast. We're going to have some surprise special guests. I'm sure we're going to be going live there from the DNC, triggering many, many more folks there on the ground. It's going to be awesome. So be sure you tune in for that. Now, I went ahead and cleared the board from our phone calls that we had earlier because I want to open up the phone only to people who have seen Hillary's America or Clinton Cash. Now, Hillary's America came out this past weekend. It actually cracked the top 10 of movies. This is what the Democrats do not want you to see, the secret history of the Democratic Party and what Hillary's America is going to mean. And also, I know Breitbart was airing Clinton Cash, the Clinton Cash documentary this weekend. So if you were one of the lucky people who got to watch either of these movies, I want you to call in. I want you to tell people what was your key takeaway from these movies and what you want to share with your fellow Americans. What can they learn from watching these movies? Now, when I was there, I obviously had the opportunity to interview Dinesh D'Souza, you know, true patriot here. And I also got to speak with Carol Swain. She played a key role in Hillary's America. She's a professor from Vanderbilt, very well-spoken, and she kind of is a recovering Democrat, if you will. She knew the truth about the Democratic Party, but she kind of just pushed it aside, like I feel a lot of other minorities within the Democratic Party do. They kind of push back the facts a little bit, but it got to a point where it was just too much She couldn't do it anymore. So I had the opportunity to speak with her. We're going to go ahead and play that video now.
Leah McAdoo with Infowars.com. I am here with Carol Swain, a very prominent voice in the movie Hillary's America, professor of political science and law at Vanderbilt. And you brought such an amazing voice to this film. Talk to me a little bit about it, because my mind is still quite blown. But I know that yours was as well at that moment, you know, being a Democrat and then sort of learning a little bit about the sordid history of the Democrat Party. Talk to me a little bit about that.
Well, I mean, I've known the history of the Democratic Party a long time because my specialty is American politics. When I got the opportunity to appear in the film, I saw it as an opportunity to maybe reach a wider audience with the true history of the party. Now, I knew the history of the Democratic Party, but I stayed in the party up until the early 2000s, and then I moved to becoming an independent, and in 2009 I became a Republican. And I believe that the Democratic Party is not the party, it's clearly not the party that a lot of African Americans believe it is, and I'm hoping that this movie will reach a much wider audience and that they will begin to see, especially African Americans, that they don't have to stay in the Democratic Party, and that there is a party that offers hope and a way out of the misery that so many people suffer.
And so you can offer some historical accuracy. I mean, what would you say is the key thing that you want to talk to these young people out there? I mean, we see right now with the Black Lives Matter movement, and these people are really activated, very politically active in their communities, but I feel as though they might be being kind of led in a certain way, but maybe they don't have the whole history. What would you say is are some of the key points that they need to understand about what they're supporting?
Well, there's so much that they don't understand, and if they are college students, then they need to read about Marxism. Maybe they'll read about it and they'll like it, but they need to know that it's pure Marxism, and study the, they should go from learning about Marxism to studying the impact that it's had on the rest of the world. I think that a lot of African Americans are being deceived. They want a better life. They want a better world. They're being used. And if they truly believe that Black lives matter, they would be concerned about the abortion rate in the Black community. In cities like New York, more Black babies are being aborted than are being born. If they truly cared about Black lives, they really would be concerned about the high Black-on-Black murder rate.
Absolutely. And one of the things that I mean, we've talked about this a lot at InfoWars, but one of the things that I thought was just really spelled out very well in this film was the KKK being the military arm of the Democratic Party. And I don't think a lot of people understand that, and to how they could overnight switch from lynching people to then all of a sudden being your savior. Talk to me a little bit about that.
Well, the thing about it, people would say, well, the KKK, that was a long time ago. And I would agree that that was a long time ago. But I believe that many of the programs that the Democratic Party pushes enslaves Blacks. And when they bring in more and more immigrants, that decreases opportunities for low-wage, low-skilled Americans of all races. So the policies of the Democratic Party are not policies that are going to enable many poor people to overcome their plight. I believe in the American dream. It's been a reality for me. I believe it can be a reality for millions of other people. And if young people want to change America, then I think that they need to equip themselves with some historical knowledge. I also believe that a part of the problem for many Americans, and again, I'm going to keep going back to Black people because I'm Black, is that we put our faith in government now. There was a time when we put our faith in God, but now it's government, and that's a mistake.
And one last question. So what we're hearing a lot now, and I don't know if this is coming out of the schools or whatever, but I hear a lot of young Black people, minorities, saying that the Constitution is not for them. And yes, of course, when it was written, it wasn't, you know, the world was not perfect. Talk to people a little bit about the Constitution. Who was it written for?
Well, the Constitution in many ways was written in a timeless manner. The framers knew that slavery was wrong. In fact, you don't find the word slave or slavery mentioned in the Constitution. Everyone knew that it would be eventually abolished. I think that when we look at our Constitution, we have to look at our freedoms. There's a reason why people are willing to risk their lives to come to America. Freedom of religion, freedom of speech, freedom of association, all of those things that we take for granted, our Bill of Rights, that's something that we should cherish. No other country in the world has come up with anything better.
Well, there you go. That was a very powerful interview with Carol Swain. You have got to see this movie, Hillary's America. The Democrats do not want you to see this film. It is going to blow your mind, even if you already kind of understand a little bit about the sordid history, especially if you're an InfoWars listener, you've heard some of these things before, but it's really spelled out and done in a very artistic way. And Dinesh D'Souza, he says that the reason why he was able to come up with this idea, kind of the plot for his film, was while he was serving time. The Obama administration was trying to make him suffer, but there he met with a lot of criminals who were explaining how they, you know, they did their crimes, and he started to recognize a pattern with how they all operate. And he said, wow, this is exactly how the Democrats operate. Are they trying to steal America? And it is really good. And I'm also now seeing a lot of callers coming in with Hillary's America as well as Clinton Cash. So we're going to be going to you in just a minute. But first, let's go ahead and talk about the big story that happened over the weekend, the DNC leaks. Of course, WikiLeaks put out about 20,000 emails, I believe, a treasure trove of documents between the DNC party as well as reporters, establishment reporters or their favored reporters with their donors, where they're asking donors for huge amounts of money and then making fun of them. Or you see sort of some inner workings there where they're making fun of particular minority groups. Meanwhile, they're staging photo ops for the minority groups. Joining me now, Margaret Howell. So let's go ahead and talk about the DNC leaks and how the narrative is kind of being pushed at this point.
Well, Leanne, mainstream media, first of all, they're saying that Russia's foreign intel agency is responsible for the leak. The focus is on Russia, not actually the treasure trove of emails and what's in them.
Right, because they need a boogeyman, because it can't be Clinton and the DNC.
Exactly. Debbie Wasserman Schultz promptly resigning, saying that she's so sorry for these insensitive and embarrassing emails. And yet, looking at the mainstream media, the DNC leaked emails. They did like a top five of the most damaging. Nothing on their list is even remotely close to the most damaging aspect of this email find. It's just
right.
Crazy that they're pointing out one thing that they did point out at Sanders' religion, and he is an atheist. He's a presumed atheist. He's of Jewish descent. Obviously, he's an atheist Jew, and they wanted to point out the DNC chief financial officer Brad Marshall. One email said it might make no difference except for Kentucky and West Virginia, which I find particularly offensive. Being from Kentucky myself, he was trying to rile up the Southern Baptists by pointing out that Sanders is an atheist because he understands that the Christian culture has a love and acceptance and they stand with the Jewish faith. So he was trying to separate those two and push it in these two states to get them to turn on Sanders, which is like, oh my gosh, wow, that's
right.
Really.
And meanwhile, at the same time, Hillary Clinton tweeted out over the weekend, like, as all of this is going on, she's putting out the video about, oh, well, Donald Trump really must like architecture or something because he's talking about the star, that there was there that whole thing and they really pushed. And within the DNC, you can see with these emails how their thing is, we've got to push how Trump is a racist, xenophobic, bigot, homophobic. They're just, that's their whole agenda, their whole operation. And so talk about an ill-timed tweet.
Speaking of racist and homophobic remarks, we found some of those too in these emails. So they wanted to find prize gays, if you will, and make them have a photo op at the DNC. They were on the hunt for these any available gays to do a photo op at the DNC. Not really sure why that would matter in terms of...
Well, just to show how diverse they are and how bad the Republicans are.
Precisely, precisely. And then they say that they went after, in a separate email, targeting Latino voters, you know, talking about the treasure trove that they are and how they're this massive brand and they need them to perpetuate this message. But then in a separate email, they go on to say that they want to have something called a Taco Bowl engagement, which sounds pretty freaking racist.
No, remember when they had Trump with his Taco Bowl?
Right.
And how that just was like on the mainstream news for days.
But they're referencing Hispanic voters as the Taco Bowl engagement.
Yeah.
Which is a little ironic.
No, it's just totally hypocritical. And that's the thing. It's almost like
Everything they say the other people are doing is what they are doing.
Exactly.
On their end.
The two big whoppers of this. The first one, so possible collusion with a Politico reporter. And Politico, they're the elitist media of Washington. They've got the trademark of all politics, you know. This investigative reporter that works for Politico, his name's Ken Bogle. It turns out he was sending his drafts to the DNC. He was checking his propaganda with the emperor before printing it, just to make
before sure. Before sending it to his own editors, he's sending it to the DNC.
Precisely. So this practice is called draft sharing, and it's right on the border. I know you're the fantastic journalist. We don't operate in this way. We typically, you don't check your propaganda memo with the people that you're supposed to be reporting on prior to publishing it. But this practice of draft sharing, it's not unethical per se. Well, obviously.
Right, but you're putting yourself out there as this unbiased.
Exactly.
That's like one of the number one tenets of journalism is to have ethics and be unbiased.
I mean, if you could be totally creamed for something like this. If you and I did this, can you imagine sending our story bylines to the Trump campaign before we publish them just to make sure that they're in line with his message? I mean, okay, right. Talk about objective reporting. And they're giving some reporters special favors in exchange for this. It's really just whack.
Right, and they have preferred journalists that they know are going to play along and go do their thing. And of course, we reported on earlier this month how they had, they were like, we've got certain reporters that we can send out to just sabotage any photo, press releases, press talkings that Trump goes to, and we can just have our reporters ask the specific questions that we want. So, I mean, you can see that they're all playing this game.
You're absolutely right. So the biggest whopper in this, it turns out that they're rewarding DNC donors with federal appointments and board commissions.
Wow.
One big example of this, a notable name, and I'm going to probably mispronounce it, Robert Pietrak, if I'm saying that correctly. He gave the Hillary Victory Fund in December $337,000, just over $300,000. And then he was magnificently given a trade commission committee appointment. So that kind of swapping of favors actually is illegal.
Yeah. Yeah. And I'm sure, you know, as they've said, that they believe the Russians have already hacked into Hillary Clinton's email and the Clinton Foundation. So I'm sure this is all going to be timing. And we might see that whole pay to play being leaked in these further emails. But of course, this treasure trove was dumped before the DNC because it implicates them and shows all these Bernie supporters how rigged the system was. But hey, Bernie says, whatever, it's fine. I knew it was rigged the whole time. Well, let's shift gears. Margaret, you're down to take some phone calls. I want to hear what people thought about the movies. We'll go ahead and go to Margaret in Oklahoma. Margaret, go ahead very quickly.
Yes, I was really blown away. I didn't expect it to be so good. But one thing that really struck me was something I had never thought of, that these liberals keep shaming us about, you know, slavery in America, but even my great-great-grandfather was in the Civil War, and our great-grandfathers died to end slavery, and right, we don't remember that. And that's a point. That you know, we're all feeling so bad, and they let them walk over us. But this is a fact. They shouldn't, you know, we shouldn't let them shame us this way.
But exactly, Margaret. Weren't you just so surprised at all of the historical facts that were presented in this film and how they have been completely twisted around to now decades later? Even Republicans believe that about themselves. I mean, it's just wicked and insane how people, history can be twisted. But, you know, there, that just goes to show you, if you don't know your history, if you want to take down all those racist statues, I mean, America, our history isn't even that long. We only have a few hundred years. So why are we going to erase the history that we want to hold on to that history? But meanwhile, it's been completely sick and twisted. Margaret, thank you so much for your valid point of view. Let's go ahead to Terry in Louisiana.
Hey, Leanne, how you doing?
Doing all right. What'd you like about the movie?
I liked everything, basically. I mean, it goes into the history of the Democratic Party and how it's steeped in slavery and Jim Crow laws and the whole anti-black thing, and how it flipped with Lyndon Johnson in the early 60s. And it has a famous quote by Lyndon. You know, I'm sure it wasn't a historically accurate film, but it was portrayed where he some of the things he said in private letters when I think he was the senator for Texas showed him saying that, you know, in a group to his close buddies. And it shows how they flipped all that. And they, you know, it's kind of they bamboozle the blacks. And it's like, give them just enough, as Lyndon said.
Right. He'll have them voting Democrat. Yeah. I mean, no, it's just, and we've reported on that here as well. But how insane is that, that they did it? It worked. Here they are voting Democrat. And even though you see all these failed cities are Democrat.
But the biggest thing to me was the whole gang, the gang criminal gangsterism that he picked up in prison, that Dinesh D'Souza picked up in prison, where they're talking about, you know, you get a plan, you hire a crew, you go out and you just execute the plan. And they use
and then deny.
deny. That's exactly what they portrayed. You know, well, most politicians, in fact, but especially the Democrats, especially the Hillary Clinton type, that's exactly what they do. Yeah, look, vote for me, you'll get a house, you get to keep your doctor, you get to keep the same plan, your health care bills are going to go down.
Send any classified emails. Oh, I didn't do this. My private server that I had stored in my bathroom closet wasn't hacked by the Russians. Oh, but the Russians are expert hackers who've been able to hack into the DNC, but they didn't get me and my superb bathroom setup there I've got for my private server. Thank you so much, Terry, in Louisiana. Excellent points. All right, let's move on quickly to Mark in Indiana.
Hello.
Hey, go ahead, Mark, real quick. What'd you like about the movie?
Oh, man, I love the whole thing. I'll tell you what, I'm going to go see it again. That's how good it was.
I know, it was so much information.
I went and seen it Saturday, and it was a hot day. And I went to the show, and when I went and seen that one, man, I was crying, you know, and I'm a man, you know, us men don't cry. But yet, I'll tell you what, it made me cry. And then at the end, when they started singing, there was a whole bunch of us at the end stood up.
Started singing along. I know we saw that in the theater we were in as well. Thank you, Mark, in Indiana. It really is very good. And that's the thing, is a lot of people get up at the end. We're hearing reports around the country that people are getting up and giving it a standing ovation. You go buy a ticket for your friend and make sure your friend is a Democrat and take him to go see this movie. All right, let's go on with Brad in Louisiana. You wanted to talk about Clinton Cash documentary.
Hi, Ms. McAdoo. Yes, I saw it twice. I thought it was great. It was very obvious to me that the only thing that the Clintons learned in law school was the term quid pro quo from that movie. And to tell you the truth, I think they've victims of arrested development. You know, they're still in that infantile concrete stage where you think the world revolves around you and it's me, me, me. There's not a benevolent bone in any one of the two Clintons' bodies. What struck me the most was the treatment of the people in Haiti.
Mm-hmm.
They are totally about themselves, for themselves. They are just as anti-American, I believe, as the Obama administration is with selling uranium to Russia and all of these deals in foreign countries with dictatorial administrations and seeing that China gets the benefits from it. Nothing for America and its peoples.
Right.
She doesn't care about women. She doesn't care about sovereignty. She doesn't care about blacks. She doesn't care about whites. She doesn't care about anything but her and money.
Exactly. And it's all about them. It has always been about them. And it is this total ploy to steal America. These families, these monarchies that we've basically adopted here in this country, that's what they're all about. It's their own new world order, and it's set up for them. It's not set up for the American people. We're going to go ahead and take one last call here from Robert in Connecticut. Go ahead.
Hey, Leanne, how are you today? Listen, I saw Clinton Cash yesterday online with Breitbart.
Mm-hmm.
One of those things that I was really surprised at, well, we know they're criminals, the Global Clinton Initiative, the big money laundering operation, payoff scam, the whole deal. But the genocide in Uganda, or Rwanda, I should say, the Hutu and the Tutsi,
explain it to me a little bit about the dynamics of the, it wasn't a tribal issue there. It showed that it was a social issue. The Tutsis had 20% of the population. They were the ranchers, and the Hutu were the farmers. Now, Clinton, following up the policies of the shadow government of George Bush, funded and supported the reinvasion of the Tutsi that moved it back in there in 1990, coming from Uganda. Now, they killed over 1.2 million people, Hutu and Tutsi, as they made their progress to the capital of Kigali. The people that were doing this, he's the president now, and the Clinton Global Initiative just gave him a big award. But he was in charge of the genocide, and the genocide essentially consisted of all the people that were in their way. And then once they got there, they blamed the Hutu on the genocide.
Wow. So,
and I was flabbergasted at the amount of money that they can believe they can get away with. When Hillary Clinton was Secretary of State, she had decisions to make at the State Department, and all of a sudden Bill Clinton's in Russia speaking for $700,000 for a speech. And, they passed the uranium deal. They've given 20% of our uranium futures, sold them to Russia.
Right. Thank you so much, Robert. Gosh, you really paid attention. I see you had to watch it twice because that's what they give you, so much information. We can see what's going on, Margaret. Why don't you think that the people wanting to vote for Hillary can't see?
You know, honestly, they believe her lies. She's working for the hard-working Americans. Give me a break. This is a woman who gives an income inequality speech in a $13,000 jacket. You talk about out of touch. I don't think that there is any worse of the havoc wreaked on our country. The Clintons coming together, wreaking hell on all of us, you know, while talking to us about income inequality. Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, and then, of course, they were trying to make fun of Ivanka for wearing one of her own dresses. Oh, way to push your own product. It was a $150 dress that she was, you know, that's her dress. Right. But meanwhile, not talking about the $13,000 Mao Zedong outfit that Hillary Clinton puts on. Total joke. You guys have got to go see these movies, Clinton Cash documentary, as well as Hillary's America. Make sure you keep this in the top 10. It's time. We're witnessing the fall of the globalists. Well, you guys tune in tonight to the InfoWars Nightly News. Jakari Jackson is going to be your host. Margaret and I are going to be breaking down these DNC leaks even further. And we are here for you. Thank you so much for supporting the broadcast. That's InfoWars Nightly News tonight, 7 p.m. Central.